No more tests.
What are you...
Not until we have a better understanding of what we're dealing with.
Look, I'll tell you exactly what we're doing. Look, just give us a minute. Excuse me, put the egg back in the cage and be gentle.
Well, I'll tell you exactly what we're dealing with here. We're dealing with a drug that is worth more than everything else we are developing combined. You make history, I make money. Wasn't that our arrangement?
No.
There are risks.
Don't talk to me about risks.
You gave your own father an experimental drug. I could finish your career with one phone call.
I'll save you the trouble, I quit.
I don't know if you guys knew, but radars are actually things they use in, like, submarines.
Welcome to TalkRadar 172.
Radar is an acronym for, reflecting and detection radar.
You caught us in the middle of us mocking our fans, which we love
to mocking our fans.
I like games radar.
But Henry, you are absolutely right. Every time I'm like, here's a new FAP. That doesn't mean what you think it means. Ah, right,
you guys might want to think of changing it. I don't think you guys know what it means.
Meanwhile, when I talk about the lovely fans of PC Gamer, I say, I enjoy reading PC Gamer because I'm an intelligent and sensible person who enjoys playing games on the finest gaming systems available.
What is that, a Dell?
Get out of here.
Dude, you're getting a Dell.
Timely. I like it. Okay.
That's a spicy meatball.
TalkRadar 172.
It's good to be back.
Welcome back, Tyler Wilde. This is your first real appearance since your exit.
Yeah, right? Kind of my real one. Yeah.
I swear to God, you were on.
Yeah, like right after. Swear
to God, I see you every night. I can barely tell. I can't tell anymore.
You did a cameo, I remember, but I don't remember.
Well, I came in. I didn't know you guys were recording, and I started asking you questions once.
Well, yeah. I'm Chris Antista. We have
Henry Gilbert, regular host
of Games.
You legally change your name to that?
It's setting in.
I'm Brett Elston.
And I am Tyler Wilde.
Of PC Gamer now. No
PC
longer Games Radar.
Gamer.
I don't let the Dead Island
videos
lie to you.
Speaking of our fans, who I love so much.
What's that, Elston?
I wanted to kick it all off with just mentioning PAX stuff really quick so that everyone hears it at the beginning. Chris, Michael, myself, Cheryl are the Radar people going, but Tyler Wilde, you will be there.
I will be there with the whole PC Gamer crew.
Yes. Lizzie will be going, and a lot of other people on the future side will be there. Most of PC Gamer and SamoaXM.
A lot of former future people.
Yeah. So if you're going, we were talking about if you do not need a pass to go to PAX to do the meetup that we're going to do Saturday afternoon. We don't know what time yet, and it could end up being Friday afternoon. Sorry, it's still in flux, but we're waiting. We're having a food truck and some tents.
Also might be in 2012.
Yes. Sponsored by a game that you give a shit about. You actually... it's one of the biggest games of the year. It'll be there giving out stuff and food, and we'll be podcasting with PC Gamer people, us, and we meet and greet.
Woo.
No booze, just like, hey, let's all hang out in the afternoon. Then Saturday night, the 27th,
my ears have perked up.
We will be going out around 9 p.m. somewhere near the convention center, and we are going to imbibe many fluids.
Did you say there's something in the forums, like asking Seattle residents?
I put it in Games Radar Club's forums, the TalkRadar podcast, where if you're not already there, you will never go. I put a thing in there asking, hey, who has any places to recommend? I know Church's wife suggested a place called Unicorn because they sell a drink called Unicorn Jizz, which did it not derail our office for minutes.
Carolyn was genuinely upset again, and
because we're like it's immortal, like, being on. Do they need to reproduce?
And then Carolyn brought her expertise to it.
She brought genuine knowledge to the table.
And then I stood up and said to Carolyn, but in Harry Potter, they bleed jizz. And just like, shut the fuck up.
They bleed
mercury.
Got
one of those looks. Like, I'm being serious.
Even if they don't have to reproduce, they should be allowed to have fun.
Exactly.
That's true. Not much of an immortal.
I don't know. When you're an immortal, after a century of jizzing, it probably gets boring.
Before we get too derailed.
I bet all unicorns are probably into autoerotic.
Before we do this again. Later we talked about how Ziggy could be crucified.
It would be difficult to crucify.
And Rayman would be funny.
He's got hands. Anyway. But yeah, if you're going to PAX, neither one of those things will require a PAX badge. So if you wanted to go, but were like, ooh, I won't have any, I never got a badge, I didn't have any money. If you can just be in the Seattle area, there's going to be a ton of readers, a ton of you guys that we saw last year. I hope everybody comes back. It was super fun.
Dude, I think fucking Ted Rossi told me he was going.
Oh,
back.
Ted Rossi?
Ted Rossi.
He's going to PAX Prime?
I think so.
Oh, nice. Oh.
Fucking wicked kid.
Ah.
He'll have to show us somewhere on the Pacific Ocean we can have roast beef at 3 in the morning.
And pee in.
Yay!
Yay!
So we'll have, we'll have details. We'll have full details shortly. We'll be tweeting. Look on Twitter. I'm Brelston, GamesRadar Twitter.
Let me just get
And Tyler has news as well.
Get my thing out of the way. Speaking of unicorns, we're probably going to be in the Unicorn Theater. PC Gamers putting on a huge and awesome panel.
Yeah.
That's, what? It's basically a the press conference that PC games don't have.
Yeah.
And it's not for the press. It's for you. But there will be big announcements, a lot of presenters. Right now, we're planning Friday at 12:30, probably. Mm-hmm. That might change. But most likely, it'll be on Friday. It'll be huge. There will be giveaways. Mm-hmm. There will be announcements
it's
of things you care about, including Minecraft things you might care about, if you like that. Maybe, possibly, the next game.
I don't know how you lined this shit
we
up.
We lined up some big...
Ridiculous.
Damn fucking... Oh, well, you guys can say fuck some big fucking shit.
Yes, well, some big fucking shit.
You have to control yourself.
Big fucking shit!
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That must be hard. That must have been hard.
It does, being the official PC magazine and everything.
Yep, you get all the capital fuck trade. Pull it out of GamesRadar shit station.
I like what Evan wrote, because this should be a verb we all use.
Mm-hmm.
We've gathered PC gaming's best minds and producers and Voltroned them together into a giant presentation-giving robot of unlimited power.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
that's one of the
Voltron stuff.
The beauties of the English language is that anything can be a verb. Mm-hmm.
You gave me credit this morning.
Is it Jaren?
What if all those pipes fell off the truck in front of us? I'm like, well, you'd have to Michael Bay around that shit.
I'm always Michael Bay.
You gotta Michael Bay that shit.
So, yeah, so anyway, look at your schedule when you get there if you're going, and you do need a pass, but go, even if you don't like PC games, like, it's going to be so much fun, so go.
And in other news, we'll be talking about a whole bunch of game-related stuff, but in other bigger news, which we'll announce at the end, somebody in this room is quitting.
That was the ominous.
I wish I was joking. And
the ominous tease at the end of the last podcast.
Uh-oh. Now they're going to be glued to the podcast / fast-forwarding to the last 5 minutes.
Skipping to the end.
No, I hope they do super glue their earbuds into their ears and listen.
No, you really should.
That's why I get to force you to things that I made something so bad, like, nah, I can't play that. But I got nothing else. You have to sit around and wait and see who's quitting.
Listen to this podcast linearly and try to pick up hints along the way.
It's
going to be fun. It's going to be like a murder mystery.
It's about the journey, not
the destination.
Journey,
not the destination. If you could just teleport there like in Star Trek, which is really good.
Star Trek is really good.
You're right. It's like, what's the point, man?
What is the point?
Because now we have the right, or at least the reason, to waste your time. I didn't want to use this at all because Charlie refused to come on, but he kept showing us commercials with the word Charlie in it.
Well, I brought up Charlie Tuna, and sorry, Charlie.
You said sorry, Charlie. I'm like, my mom always says that to me. Why? Yeah. Was that ever a catchphrase? Was there somebody named Charlie needed to be apologized to?
Yeah, my mom said it all the time. Well, it's because Charlie Tuna didn't want to be
Is a total homo.
He didn't want to be the star. He didn't want to be the, like, label dude of Starkist Tuna. He wanted somebody else to be the cover. I'm like, no, it's going to have to still be you. Sorry, Charlie.
And they wanted fish that taste great, not fish with great taste.
Yeah.
Well, he was a bird.
Really? You remember this too?
He was a bird that wore a beret.
We just watched it.
But Charlie had the good plan. And this does not pass muster if I had the energy to care about today's show. He just had a bunch of stuff to say. It's faith.
Once upon a time, there was an engineer. Choo-choo Charlie was his name, we hear. He had an engine and he sure had fun. He's good and plenty candy to make his train run.
Charlie says...
A battle of jellyfish?
Charlie says...
A battle of jellyfish?
Charlie says...
A battle of jellyfish?
The one love the candy that I love so well.
That was so retarded.
That was the dumbest thing. Like,
Choo-choo Charlie.
I hope you guys have a lot of context for that 1950s commercial for the horrible candy.
I don't know, but you keep in the forums. I want to see some Choo-choo Charlie.
That's right.
Coming
I can
my
be
way.
Totally irresponsible right now. You know I could be really irresponsible? I had taken it.
I never liked good and plenty.
What are we? It's fucking terrible.
It's a bad candy.
Yeah, Charlie's like, do you mean the delicious licorice? I'm like, that's an oxymoron. It doesn't exist.
Licorice is horrible.
Not a big licorice fan.
No.
Licorice.
Who is?
Leftover from World War II. I'm guessing from the Nazis. The Nazis like licorice.
It's almost anus.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Ugh. Licorice.
Gross.
What?
Fire at the center of...
That's not...
That was last time.
I remember hating it when I played Candyland. I hated going to the licorice area.
even in theme, I hate licorice.
You want to stay out of the licorice district. It gets a little dark there, if you know what I'm saying. It's full of dark licorice, is what I'm saying.
Wow.
Boy.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
Wow.
This is something I ask people, but apparently I'm in the extreme minority. Your version of Candyland.
You're an extreme minority.
I'm in the extreme minority. This is a Candyland conversation.
Candyland.
Yep.
Who had Candyland?
I played it.
Did your Candyland area have people on the board in living beings?
Well, yeah, there was like the fudge guy and the lollipop dude.
I had been playing Candyland forever, but I didn't. I was playing like my mom's version from the 60s, and it had none of that shit. And there were just lollipops and candy, like no people or things, just pieces of candy.
I only knew the people.
You lucky fuckbucks. Yeah. What do we have to talk about? I have no idea.
I played my mom's like 60s version of Sorry, which was kind of neat.
I remember I played Snakes and Ladders a lot. Not Shoots, but Snakes.
Oh, I see.
Original version.
Snakes and Ladders is better.
Well, why did they change it?
Cooler snakes don't make sense.
Snakes are a little too devilish.
I guess you wouldn't slide down a snake, I guess.
Yeah, I would if it was a giant, like anaconda, and I had to escape. And I'm glad slide down it.
This is a game conversation.
What do you think it would be like to be eaten by a snake?
Well, maybe. Mm. Well, I always thought.
Well, John Voight taught us that it'll squeeze you tighter than your true love. And then he's regurgitated in Jennifer Lopez's mouth, I think.
But I think the snakes were because it was isn't it a game from India originally, and it was snakes as part of some Hindu.
You're making
thing.
That up.
No, I swear. Get off of Wikipedia. I feel like I learned that in a special. Not what was the name of that class? Like,
gifted
class.
You know what we have to talk about? At some point in this podcast, I'll tell you all some Logan Decker stories.
Really?
Logan Decker, editor-in-chief of PC
Gamer.
They
don't even know who that is.
That's a character.
You made him up.
I made him up. But I got a few things Logan told me that I'll tell you guys. But
I don't know. You want to talk about today's feature about the 3DS?
We had a feature on the 3DS?
Sure did. Previewing this fall. All right, so, damn it, I was going to write I got to write that news story. Damn it. All right. Anyway, you'll have seen that news story already. but moving on.
God damn it.
It's doom and gloom about the 3DS. Boo-hoo, everything sucks. But we did a feature day about what the fall games are going to be on the 3DS, and it's, I don't think, a bad lineup.
Wait.
But on the topic of the 3DS, it is now too late to be part of that ambassador program and get your 23 games.
Oh, really? They
crossed the line. It was the 12th, and this is posting on the 12th. Today is
the
12th.
11th, I thought.
Okay, 11th at midnight in Eastern Standard Time in America.
But for the premium users listening to us live, Target and Walmart have started selling it early.
The gold members?
The gold members,
Well, gold lets you hear it soon, but platinum.
Oh, platinum.
You get to hear it before we record it.
Hi, platinum members. Amazing. They're talking back in our ears right now.
I know. Man, there's only like 7 of them, but I mean, it's
Mike.
Like
Mike. Oh, man. That's hilarious.
Wait. If you could only see this, one of them is sodomizing me with their black American Express card. It's too expensive for most of you. That's why I've never mentioned it.
Your butthole is a mag stripe reader?
I
you spit all over yourself.
Did I?
I saw a bunch of saliva.
Oh, you're a mess.
Yeah. Fucking this dude. We live together. We go to the gas station. We've been like sort of like vaguely daring one another to drink weird energy drinks.
Oh, yeah.
And whatever we drank this morning, Red Line?
Red Line.
Fuck me,
we're getting
dude.
Into the Red Line.
I drink like 9 cups of coffee a day, 2 Red Bulls, and usually take Adderall. And this is like. Fuck.
Dude, I've been like fucking trying to do backflips off my desk
all day.
I've been
sweating the whole day.
I'm just in a bowl of sweat right now.
So Red Line.
Red Line. Yeah, it's got like a warning on the label that's like, I don't know, it's probably like a 10,000 word essay on like how you shouldn't drink this if you are human.
Look, they list an ingredient and then they tell you this ingredient is terrible.
You better watch that. You pregnant?
Don't drink this.
Oh boy.
Only drink a quarter of the bottle. And
you have a heart problem? No. Do you have a heart? No, don't drink this.
But here, watch this. Watch what I do, Hank. But also under the ingredients, they listed fall 3DS games.
Wow. That's interesting.
Namely, it says it has your daily dose of Super Mario 3D Land.
Oh, yeah, there was a thing today. I was going to write a news story about it, but then Nintendo immediately, or like By the time I was going to write the news story, Nintendo retracted it, but they gave the release date for MTV's blog. They gave the release date for Mario 3D Land, which is according to that blog, November 13th and December 7th for Mario Kart 7. But by the time I was about to write the story and rechecking the source, they're like, it says, Nintendo says that those release dates are unofficial and that they've only officially said, and so. What really happened was a PR person fucked up and said the release date early, and now Nintendo's like, no, those are unofficial. Those aren't the release date. No.
Those companies would stop doing that shit. Yeah. Like, it's the internet. It's too late. Everyone already knows.
And those dates are the perfect dates. Like,
yeah.
Of course they're going to put out their tentpole Mario release on November 13th, like the same week every game comes out. Yeah. Like, but yeah, there's Mario 3D Land.
I can't believe they do Mario Kart that late, though.
Well, December 7th. That's basically the last week.
What day is it?
December 7th for Mario Kart 7.
Bad time.
I just can't believe you're getting a Mario the main Mario Bandicoot game before the Mario Kart. Usually,
it's a weird.
Super Mario 3D Land. I played a couple of levels that I did like at E3, I'm getting a very kind of plodding, uninteresting vibe.
I didn't hate it at all, but when somebody said Crash Bandicoot, I'm like, fuck me. Wow.
Yeah, but the trailer from E3, there were levels that were like, oh, this looks interesting. This is an interesting concept.
There'll be cool stuff in it for sure.
I don't think it's going to be the equivalent of a galaxy.
And then there's also Shinobi, which, did anyone ever see that?
Chris played it. What did you think of Shinobi?
It was kind of great, and it's going to die a miserable death. It's a hardcore Sega game coasting on the Shinobi legacy, which has done nothing
which is
ever.
Not a legacy.
And it's just a great, super hardcore. I don't want to scare people away by saying it's super hardcore, but it's just a very straightforward side scroller with great 3D elements, like weird 3D elements I've never seen people do before. Mm-hmm. And you probably won't be expecting certain things that this game does.
I'm interested to play it.
Yeah, it was really cool.
It's strange, though, that Sega's putting that and Sonic Generations out the same month.
Basically in the same month, yeah. Well, Shinobi wasn't going to be in November. They pushed it. It got delayed
Before they give up on the platform.
Yeah. That was Sega half giving up on the platform. But this fall is also very pivotal to the 3DS, I think. But
I had proposed that we say the fall games and have a checklist so you can cross them off once they're canceled.
No, I think...
A graveyard of 3DS. Yes.
I think at least on the first page of this article, there's nothing that's going to be delayed.
Kid Icarus, I can't believe, keeps getting pushed back. It's like I played it in January, and there was like a very large demo of it, and then it was at E3 again, and it was the same demo.
Well, but they also had the multiplayer demo too,
I didn't see it. Oh. Like they mentioned it, but I didn't play it.
I remember it at the press conference.
Did multiplayer in that game?
Yes.
Yeah. Godspeed.
Don't you remember? You were at the E3 press conference where they talked about it.
Yeah, but I had zoned out. I was thinking too much about the Wii U.
Yeah.
Well, you were just waiting for the Wii U to be talked about.
I was thinking how I could enroll at Wii U.
Whoops, I hit play on this video. So, damn it. The December release date for Mario Kart 7 is actually kind of in line with Mario Kart DS, which I believe came out in December of 2005. So,
It sounds right
to
me.
It worked for them.
As long as it's the first week of December, I don't think that's too late. Yeah. But
notice they're putting a game out on December 7th, but 9/11, which is... a Sunday this year, which is when Nintendo usually releases their games. You'll notice this year the new DS, the Flame Red DS, and Star Fox 64 are coming out September 9th, the Friday before the Sunday. And I mentioned that in one of the interviews and one of the appointments. I'm like, oh, that's a Friday. That's weird. They're like, yeah, we're trying something new. It's like, no, you're just avoiding September 11th.
Avoiding September.
Because I guarantee...
Hey, for the 10th anniversary of September 11th, pick up Star Fox.
And think of Star Fox, won't you?
Yes, think of your Flame Red DS while you're thinking of 9/11.
You know, think about flying and trying not to hit buildings.
The Flame Red DS comes out on the same day as Star Fox 64.
We're trying to figure out how to say...
Do a barrel roll!
Never forget.
Star Fox 64... But that's also... They did the same thing in Japan. In Japan, when they launched in July, Star Fox 64 3D, they also launched the Flare Red in Japan.
But they moved it away from the date of the Hiroshima 3DS. Bombing?
I don't know what. No, that was in August.
Was it?
Yeah, I think so.
I know it was done by a ship called the Enola Gay Walk.
It was a plane called the Enola Gay.
Thank you, sixth grade.
Enola Gay Walk. Yeah. All of that was courtesy of sixth grade.
Sweet Enola Gay.
Yeah, actually, now that I think about it with the math, like, if Mario's November and Mario Kart is December, where, like, Icarus isn't going to be before those.
Like, October is all they could do.
But Icarus is... Nah, no way. They'd be showing us more if Icarus was October, right?
I just decided I don't want to talk about it.
Wait, but there's more.
Okay, give me some
Move
more.
Move to the next page. These are the more obscure ones.
Well, the secure are going to care even less.
I'll care more.
Shin Megami Tensei Devil Survivor Overclock.
Yeah, look. I'm betting a lot of people out there maybe skipped the original Devil Survivor on the DS, which I gave it
I
nine.
Know I did.
You betcha.
It was awesome,
I know all
though.
But 12,000 of you did.
And if you've been waiting for... an RPG on the 3DS, this is a really great one. It's really good. It's got more stuff in it than the original.
Is it an RPG or is it a tactics game?
Well, it's a strategy RPG, but it's great.
Boy.
It's a grid-based strategy RPG. Like, love if you've ever liked Final Fantasy Tactics or Disgaea, it's a great game.
And Star Fox 64 3D comes out September 9th, as we already said, which is fantastic. The last time I previewed it, it was really fun. And it's much prettier. They've added new graphic elements, and the multiplayer is actually a lot of fun. Bit Trip Saga?
Yeah, it's a collection of all the Bit Trip games that were released on WiiWare. And those, I never played any of them. But
didn't Amanaguchi do the music to one? Runner, maybe?
That sounds right.
And then November 8th is Cave Story 3D.
Mm. Oh, boy.
Michael liked that.
Well, that's
which
something.
I love
Cave Story.
Story's
great.
But the 3DS one I'm not sold on yet.
Oof, thank you, buddy.
It's kind of a weird... that weird thing where, like, we improve the graphics and it loses its charm.
Mm.
And
it'll
it's
happen.
Like,
and made it in 3D.
Beautiful, it has such beautiful graphics, the 2D ones.
Like, if you want to play a charming roguelike on PC. Try Dungeons of Dreadmore. I'm just throwing that in.
You're
just
if you played Binding of Isaac
I'm just saying PC stuff. What?
No.
Have you played the Binding of Isaac yet? That's the one PC game I'm interested in.
No.
The Super Meat Boy guys. You're in the box, man.
Yeah, no. I have not. No.
Must have been... let me know when you get a build in. I want to see it.
After that is Tales of the Abyss, which is a port slash
PS2 port
of the PS2 game, which Tales of the Abyss I played. It is actually pretty good as far as JRPGs go, and the PS2 one at least had one of the really good rockin' intros from the top 7 rockin' intros from like 4 years ago.
What can you really say about an abyss? I mean, there's nothing there.
I'm sure there's a tail there somewhere.
There's a,
do you think?
Well,
I think so.
Probably a lot of stuff fell in it. So.
Oh, good point.
Oh, I also want to point out about the Devil Survivor game, too, that it comes out this month. Like, a lot of these games you're going to have to wait another few months for, but this Devil Survivor comes out in 2 weeks. Like,
By the way, Henry's wearing a gold chain that says Devil Survivor on it.
I wish. If Atlas would send me one, I would wear it every day.
Jeez. Harvest Moon, The Tale of Two Towns.
Another Harvest Moon game,
okay. Yeah, Frogger 3D, which, like, surprisingly, a lot of people said was good.
Carolyn was pretty positive on it. It's made by the creator. It's made really by the man who coined 1 million troops.
Oh, wow.
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 Yeah, well done.
I actually had it there.
Dr. Lautrec and the Forgotten Knights?
That's Konami's gigantic ripoff of Professor Layton. Like,
what is it
huge.
Called?
Huge.
It's called Dr. Lautrec and the Forgotten Knights. The Trek.
Wow.
Like, it's a dude with a giant hat.
Dr. Not Layton.
Dr. Not.
It's all anime e
like Dr. Layton.
Can we write about it and say Dr. Layton to the party?
Yes, that was the joke I was
That's
trying
basically
to like that. And then Pokemon Rumble Blast, which nobody gives a shit about.
What the hell is that?
It's basically have wind up toys of Pokemon that kind of bump into each other.
Jesus.
Wow.
Would you mind if I just try and see what the sound effect is?
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, actually, Pokemon Rumble, it comes out October 24th. That was one of the other redacted release dates.
Oh, really?
So if that's October, Icarus will not also be October.
They would, because they know that game's not going to, like, blow through
I
the roof
not
or
now.
But the thing is, with the DS is so small install base, it's like 830,000. It's like, if
that's just America.
I know it's just America, but it's like, if Mario Kart, if it's one-to-one, and everyone who has a 3DS buys Mario 3D Land, that's still such a sad
state
for 3DS.
I think their plan is that, like, 500,000 people will buy a 3DS to play that game.
They need to hire more expensive celebrities to play the commercial.
I feel like the price drop will help a lot, and those are strong games, so it'll probably be a pretty good... Yeah. It almost has to be a good holiday, because if it's not, that also spells trouble for the Vita in general.
You know, I think... Well, yeah, well, the Vita...
Vita is, like, so totally fucked, and it didn't even do anything yet.
Yeah. Nintendo got a real gift by the Vita not coming out in the holidays in America and Europe. Like,
that's true.
They do have to fight it in Japan, but, like... If Vita's only launching in Japan, then it's probably going to have a very shitty lineup. Like,
probably.
I bet it'll have, what, a Mahjong game and a Ridge Racer, and that's
racist.
No, look at the Mahjong. You look at the N64
launch. It'll have a Dynasty Warriors.
It was Mario, Pilo Wings, and chess or something.
Yeah, it was always like...
chess masters.
Yeah. Super easy games
like that. Chris and I had 100% of our daily Vita today in our red lines.
Jesus Christ.
I like mopping your chest down or something. What are you doing?
Ugh,
oh, my God.
He just hand-mopped his chest.
Wow. I'm really sweaty.
Put it near Henry.
Fucking,
yeah.
Henry's, like, recoiling.
I'm nervous. There's an announcement coming. Fuck.
Well, anyway, so the 3DS
is boring and not worth your...
Doesn't look that bad. I'll admit it's not a super stellar lineup.
I haven't heard about it until right now for months.
Yeah.
It's not a great system.
I think Nintendo really overestimated themselves in this case. And, like,
I'm just looking at you right now and like expecting like some level-headed response to Nintendo, and you're wearing all the characters in your shirt. Like,
no,
it's got like Mario and Luigi back with their arms crossed, like it's Beverly Hills.
No, I see a piranha, a blooper. So,
here's the silver lining I was thinking of with it though.
Is a paratrooper.
Nintendo sees, like, they've had to really apologize to their hardcore base, and, like, they're going to keep doing things to apologize.
The 20 game thing was evident of, like, oh shit, we fucked
up. The 20 game thing, and then Iwata saying he's taking a pay cut, like, they thoroughly...
That's Japanese shame right there. Like, that's that kind of shit where they come bow to apologize to their public. Like, that's...
Well, and also, like, it's...
That would never fucking happen over here. Like, we had our whole country going in the toilet, and nobody wants to be like, guys, I'm sorry I misled the whole country and invested in a bunch of shit that was bankrupt. Whoops.
But
like,
I think it's...
I'm going to take my millions and just fuck off. How's that?
I think Nintendo's also going to take a lot more chances on hardcore, like, sequels.
Well, they've got to try.
Because, like, I don't think you'd see Luigi's Mansion 2 ever, but, like, or...
Luigi's Mansion.
I think that might be canceled.
No way.
It's not canceled.
You don't think so?
Nintendo's not going to cancel something like that.
My mom would cry if that was canceled.
They're not showing a lot of it because it's an early 2012
release. It's the next year.
I think it's Mario 128.
Stop it. Stop it.
So anyway, I think on the plus side, Nintendo is going to like want to try to get more hardcore. That's all. Had an emergency.
Okay, here's Logan Decker story number one, my new boss. I'm just going to interject with this.
LD.
He comes up to my desk
the other day.
And just says, you know what, Tyler, you know what gave me nightmares when I was a kid? Okay. Like, they would tell me, like, my dad would tell me, what if you were, like, sliding down the longest banister in the world? Like, you just keep going and going. You're sliding down the banister, all right, and you get faster and faster and faster, and you get so incredibly fast, and this thing never ends, and then it turns into a razor blade. That's what kept me up at night. And then I didn't sleep for a week.
Why wouldn't you just jump off?
What? It turns into you're having fun, and then it turns into a razor blade.
Well, he didn't say you're having fun. I'd be terrified after like an hour of that.
Well,
not to mention, the friction would burn your
nuts.
Here's
story number two.
It's pretty good description of Logan that even in all our office conversations in the middle of the day, he talks to me. He talks about like he's fucking with me while I'm high.
He comes up the other day and just says, did I ever tell you about how when my uncle was in the army, they had to take his eyeball out of the socket, and then like they pointed it like at his other eyeball? What would that look like? I'm just like, I'm trying to work. What?
It's like I'm smoke pot for the first time, and he's sitting me down like, say hello. Well, you don't have to be fucking racist about it. Like, that's like, that's my interaction with Logan.
More later. Logan Decker. Follow him on Twitter because he's fascinating. Man. He's a fascinating person.
Which is, Twitter is a rock legend, which is an anagram.
He changed it back.
It was. Oh. He changed it to just Logan Decker.
Oh, did he?
Which,
Gary Steinman's is a Tiny Man Rages is an anagram for his name.
Yeah, no.
Fucking no idea. No idea.
Internet anagram generator was popular.
I've done mine.
Wow, it's
burn.
Look, what has PC Gamer done?
Burn. Yeah, I'm cynical now. But Logan Decker is just Logan Decker. And is that not the coolest name in future?
I
Logan
hate it. It reminds me of Wolverine and Blade Runner at the same time.
I know. Perfect. He is. Well, I wish I had his
I know it's
name.
Not Deckard. Please. fucking correct me on that.
You know, it's a dagger.
It was a teeth.
Whatever. I wish A-R-D, I was being Logan
yes,
Decker.
I get it. Fucking kill me. Fuck all of it.
I know my name anagrams to lobster tint.
Oh, really? I'm a reedy twill or elderly wit.
Antichrist. Yes. Thank you.
That's unbelievable.
With two letters left out. Yeah. I'll put them somewhere.
Yeah.
I don't remember
what. Yeah. And then Dan.
You'll sell a vowel. It's cool.
Dan Amrick was rancid ham.
So much like him.
A little bit of Dan.
I think he adopted a kitty cat.
Dan, as well, will be at PAX.
Does that mean mistress?
Oh, he sure will.
No, on his Facebook, he was like, hey, meet Victoria.
Oh, he did. He adopted
fresh
a cat.
Why would you name a cat Victoria? I don't like naming pets human names. This is my dog, Jim.
And that's also a weird human name, Victoria.
Yeah. If they could call her Vicky, I would figure.
No, Vicky, that's horrible. What the hell's wrong with him?
Vicky? Dan, get...
Hey, Vicky.
Look, I'm going to call Dan.
Don't call Dan. I don't like this.
Call Dan.
How about Kramer? I don't call him.
Kramer?
What? Hey, Kramer.
Why don't you call him, like, Meowie Poo or something? Yeah. Come on, use a normal name.
Name it after a video game character, you weirdo.
Yeah. Freak.
Hey, I think I know a question of the week.
What are we, Pickle Feather McGillicuddy?
Shut it.
Is that our guy?
Yeah. Chris,
can someone hand me a booze?
What do you call him when you're mad at him, though? With a short and tense...
MP.
That's cute, MP. Though.
Can you say that angrily, though?
It'd be more like...
McGilly?
Like Pick?
Pick?
Pick? Cuddy?
Yeah. What you doing, FPF?
Cuddy, sweetie.
What are you doing there?
What are you doing there, Paul F. Tompkins? Put it up.
Paul F.
Tompkins. Can we have a kitten named Paul F. Tompkins?
Can we
get a kitten?
I'm totally behind that.
No?
I want to have, yes, little Paul F. Tompkins.
Yes, even the cat had to agree with the Actors Guild and had to distinguish himself with the F. The Cat Guild.
Yeah, John C. Catty.
Oh, man.
John Meow Thompson.
Let me tell you one of my favorite things I saw.
Please, Henry.
Okay. I went to the Paul F. Tompkins show in San Francisco this year, and he's telling a story about how he does a voiceover in Magnolia.
Yes.
It's about Magnolia.
I was there. Was this a different
thing? No, this is a different thing.
Yeah, were you talking to Jason Robards? What the hell else?
No, this is a different one. How he goes. So he goes to the house that the director of Magnolia is renting, and then he goes to the house the director of Magnolia is renting for the movie, mm-hmm. to read the script. And then, in comes Tom Cruise and sits next to him. And he's just like, oh, hey, I'm Tom. Nice to meet you. Like, oh, you're Tom. Oh, hey.
Hello.
That'd be so weird sitting next to the most famous person on Earth.
Wow.
I was listening to some... No, we're talking about other comedians.
Yeah. We shouldn't at least talk about...
Let's talk about games.
I can't. We can talk about games.
Yeah, hey, let me tell a story.
Henry, I want you to tell me.
Well, I think my apartment may be haunted.
Really?
Well, now all the windows were closed in my apartment yesterday. I came home.
But you keep them open all the time?
I always keep them open. Ooh. I like the breeze blowing in. That's one of my favorite things about living here instead of Florida.
Yeah.
Can I bring something with like a meter and like a needle that moves over to your apartment and like pretend to like
measure the AC? I leave my windows open all the time to air out my funk.
Oh yeah. No, we mean like almost just the two of us is a lot of funk.
But it was
God,
so
we're
it was,
fucking slobs though.
It was no, we're funky. It's cool.
All right.
It was just creepy to come home and see like, man, it's really stuffy in here. Oh, this one window closed. Maybe there was an earthquake and shook it loose or something. And then I see, oh no, this window that you need to latch is closed. This other one is closed. Like, I think what probably happened is my landlady just went in there. They were doing road work.
Your landlady's still alive.
Yes.
It's not a ghost.
Well, no. So I think it was they're doing road work in my neighborhood, and maybe they said like, "Hey, you should close the windows because a bunch of fumes are going to be on the street."
That sounds for mosquitoes.
Stupid. It was a ghost.
Right. I think you should go with ghosts.
Well, I guess we'll see ghost. If it's ghost if my windows are closed again today. See or if my chairs are all upside down.
See if it tries to blow you like Dan Aykroyd in Ghostbusters.
That's a pretty hot scene.
Okay, what the fuck are you guys talking about?
That was
about?
Like Henry's haunted, and I learned what a
blowjob... Henry himself is haunted?
Yes, Henry is haunted.
Henry is haunted.
I learned what a blowjob was from Ghostbusters. Like, wait a minute. Why
is that lady moving her head towards his pants?
Why is that happening?
And then you learn that everyone crosses their eyes when they get a blowjob.
That's true. That's I should start doing that. Maybe that's why I don't get as many.
You have to approach them with your eyes crossed.
I meant to say that's why I don't get as many.
They're like,
the M is for mad.
That's you're just not being comical enough when receiving a blowjob.
I should be more vaudevillian.
Really, look at
that.
Make sure you look right at the camera. I should wear a hat just so I can lift it up and shake it as I'm getting one. Anyway, Yeah, the only
The 360 is still on. We should turn that off.
Well, speaking of 360, we turned that on earlier today to do the Freddy Krueger Mortal Kombat FAP.
And I captured this last week. There is a story mode. We didn't know how to get to it, nor did we have the time to find out because we had to run to a meeting. But the FAP, dude.
You basically had a half hour.
Your response to the Babeality, like, that moved you in a weird way. Well, and you're so happy about it, and it made me super happy.
Well, I did not expect them to go that deep. Like,
me either.
I just expected, like, yeah, it's Freddy. They got Freddy. Whatever.
His fatality references who he is, and his moveset, like, there's something called the Power Glove. The Power Glove.
Yeah. Well, even his first fatality is referenced, like, the first movie that ended the scene with the blood shooting out of the bed.
No, it's really cool if you're a Nightmare on Elm Street fan, or if you hate Robert Englund.
Yeah. Well, it's not the likeness either of Rorschach slash guy from Bad News Bears.
Every time I try and say that actor's name, I end up saying the name of the dude who shot Martin Luther King. So I'm not even going to attempt it.
Jack Haley. Earl Haley.
There you go. Yeah. Not going to even try. I wasn't even going to try.
James Earl Haley. He was in the Bad News Bears, and then he was in, and then he was Rorschach. Wait, he was the perfect Rorschach.
And he's hilarious and... got the name of the movie where he cuts his dick off. It's a really depressing
Little
one. Little Children, that's the one. Spoiler, my bad.
Yeah, I didn't know that. See that movie.
I did not, like, that made my toes curl.
Yeah.
It made my dick curl.
Yeah, he plays a pedophile who cuts his dick off to save him from himself.
Wow. Hey, remember that back...
And then he plays a child molester.
I can honestly... It's awesome that I know for so much for a fact that the Little Children in GamesRadar demographic have no crossover. There's no Venn diagram that exists. I can
remember the trashy talk show days in the 90s? They had a guy on who basically he was so offended by this gay guy hitting on him that he then cut his dick off and flushed it down the toilet to say, like, no, see, I'm not interested in you.
I'm sure that's what it was. It wasn't the temptation, oh my God, why does this feel so right? I can't listen to you anymore.
You see the quote from Jeremy Irons this week?
Jeremy Irons?
Yeah.
Was it a scar?
One of these. No, sadly, it wasn't a scar, but, like, there was a quote from Jeremy Irons.
Simple Simon.
Yeah, no, he's so good with a vengeance, but he's like, man, any woman worth her salt knows that if a guy touches her butt, like, she can just roll with it and be like, no, that's cool.
Atta boy.
And just like, you know, it's a friendly greeting. it's just saying hi. And it's like, what?
Jeremy Irons,
I don't even know if we can play it, but, like, I just watched Patrice O'Neill special on Netflix, and there's just a whole section
probably not
on harassment, which is just him like, yeah, I know it's wrong, but I like it. I know it's sorry.
That was fantastic.
Like, it was awesome.
It's just, we should all be able to harass.
He's like,
you know,
look, just let me harass you, God. I can never harass. Like, I don't know. I lost my fucking. He's like, I'm a dinosaur. You know, this isn't right.
It's
know.
So weird. Like, I disagree with him on so much shit, but I still find him really funny. Comics, yeah. Like, I loved him on Tough Crowd, even though I don't know. Just some. I don't want to get off on the Tough Crowd discussion.
And I want to get in touch with him at some point because he called the fucking Halo 2 gravity gun a tickle beam, and I lost my mind. lost my mind. A very specific video.
Wait, Halo 2 or Half-Life 2?
Half-Life 2, yeah, my bad.
That's okay.
Drunk and caffeinated and sweaty, we played Mortal Kombat 9.
Which will be part of the 24-hour marathon. The schedule is live on the site now.
We took a funny picture today.
Yes, the picture is in the article.
Oh, I wish I could have been in it, but I was in a meeting.
But you'll be part of the 24-hour marathon.
Absolutely. I'll be playing some PC games. I'll be playing largely probably a PC game that is actually Super Street Fighter 4.
Tyler will be playing. He will be only Minecraft.
I love it. No.
Minecraft is in there, I think.
Counter-Strike.
I'll be playing a lot of Street Fighter,
Lefting
probably.
Lefting 4 Dead.
You know why? Because, like, I just got into Street Fighter.
Let's figure out the account. I would love to play Counter-Strike with some readers.
There's a Counter-Strike source time period as well.
Oh, yeah. We'll play Counter-Strike.
I liked that when we were talking about it with Michael. Michael was like, look, guys, I don't want to be the only guy on PS3 again. Please.
I'll play. I mean, yeah, we'll bounce around a lot, but I just want to make sure that all the sides are represented and there's people playing shit at all times, which there will be.
Except for Nintendo.
We'll be streaming on Justin TV. Yeah, no Nintendo stuff.
It's impossible.
That is their fault. Carolyn said she wants to do some Pokemon giveaways during that time period, which she can do.
That'd be madness.
That's ridiculous.
We're
Combo Breaker.
Check out it's probably on the homepage or not, but whatever. It's August 19th and 20th, 5 p.m. Pacific to 5 p.m. Pacific.
Man!
We'll be playing, let me see if I remember off the top of my head. I don't have it in front of me, but we're kicking it off with Black Ops at 5 p.m.
Just look at the site.
Codblock. It's Codblock. Not on the site yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
I'm saying the readers, the listeners to the site. We'll include the article.
Yeah, well, in general, just if you want to know, because you're not next to your computer right now, Chris.
Fucking hot.
We'll be playing Gears 2.
I still have shit I prepared.
All right, we'll be playing Gears 2, Black Ops, Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. We're playing a little bit of Blur.
Play that on PC.
Yes.
Yeah. With you guys.
We're playing Counter-Strike Source, StarCraft 2. There's a League of Legends time period as well. We're going to do Dead Space 2 and Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. Mm-hmm. And lots of other stuff. Yeah, just check it out on the site. Mortal Kombat MVC 3, Street Fighter Arcade Edition.
Mortal Kombat just had the Freddy Krueger character unleashed upon it.
Yep.
If I could stop you from talking about Mortal Kombat again.
A malevolent spirit of the dream realm. Freddy Krueger preys on the souls of the living while they sleep.
I know.
I know.
90% of the players in Mortal Kombat do not know.
You think so?
I don't think Freddy's as famous as he used to be.
Yeah, but if you're into Mortal Kombat, you were probably in a Nightmare on Elm Street. I don't know.
I think there's a degree, like the amount that those movies are rotated, I think most people would know what Freddy Krueger is.
I guess they don't hear much anymore.
If you're an old Mortal Kombat fan, then you definitely were Freddy.
Do you have more sounds from them meeting each other?
When Shadow Khan attempted to steal Earthrealm's souls, Freddy brought him into the Dream Realm and challenged him to battle. Uh-huh. Aware of Freddy's dream-fueled powers, a cunning Shao Kahn pulled Freddy back into the waking world, making him mortal once again.
Freaking cunning. Why didn't anyone think of that?
I know.
Like, they face actually, him in the real world.
When Shao Kahn tried to steal the souls of the WB-verse.
I know. I love that Warner Brothers is a fucking legitimate video game company, and I did want to do... Maybe we'll make that question the week. I don't fucking know. Where, like, what Warner Brothers character... I want Ron Weasley in Mortal Kombat. I want Ron Weasley.
Well, they got the movie rights.
All right. Let's not go there.
Rupert Grint.
I want Riggs from Mortal Kombat. Want Mel Gibson as a playable character.
My brother's made something awesome.
Is he too old for that shit?
I hope you don't say Fear 3.
No.
Batman? Was it Batman?
Yeah, Batman.
I just want them to add fucking Jason already. Like, right. Have them both in there.
Well, I know that if you have to pick between the two, Freddy fits more because he does mystical shit.
I agree.
Oh, Mortal Kombat.
Warner Brothers published Bastion, which is super cool.
Did they really?
Yeah, they published it. Right, yeah. And that was super giant game. What was that?
The developer?
Big. Huge games? Big Huge Games? I think it was Super Giant.
I mean, I have one more sound effect, not the Tron.
And Bastion is awesome.
Yeah,
give it a shot.
Pretty cute.
Coming out on PC real soon.
Two demonically powered razor gloves, a newly mortal Freddy Krueger is determined to kill Shao Kahn. Only then can he return to the Dream Realm. To continue his true passion, torturing the youth of Elm Street.
Freddy wins.
Is that really all Freddy cares about? Just Elm
Street?
Torturing
the youth.
Well, Elm Street, specifically?
That's his motivation. He gets, he's getting back at the youth.
Yeah, but
of
Elm Street, right?
Yeah,
I was going to say, like, what
of
if...
Of the people who had him killed. Like, he's going after their children specifically.
But, like, what if... Like, what if
that's why he never went to Manhattan. He didn't give a fuck about those kids.
Right.
What about, like, the suburban sprawl, like, pushes Elm Street out against, you know, bulldozed?
Elm Street was redistricted.
Yeah, and...
You know what? You know, no one brought that to Freddy's
attention. I lived on Elm Street, by the way.
Did you really?
Yeah, for a while.
Wow.
Well, they might rename it, and then Freddy's just going to be like, nah, this is still my Elm Street. Get ready for your worst nightmare and a pun-filled joke around. I really like comic books. What are you going to do to me, Freddy?
you do a great impression in the FAP of
Freddy.
Freddy introducing a story in Freddy's nightmares.
Painting this picture.
Henry remembers the show more than I ever could.
I remember that one well because I thought Freddy was really cool, but I actually didn't see a Freddy movie until after The Sixth came out on VHS, and then we rented all of them. But like, I thought Freddy looked awesome, and they marketed Freddy to kids.
Oh yeah,
absolutely.
Oh yeah.
Like,
well, that was kind of wrong. That was the '80s and early '90s. Was RoboCop, Terminator, Predator. All this shit was marketed to kids
but
with
Freddy
toys.
Freddy is a full-on horror thing.
Yeah,
and he also murders.
aliens as a child murderer.
Like, specifically as a child.
That's different than, like,
well,
a predator.
Well, they didn't start marketing him to kids. Yes, it was teens who could get into rated R movies. And then, or wait, was the first one even rated R?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Well, I'm just, you know what it's like back then. Like, they was like, PG-13. No,
the first one's like a legitimate horror movie. Like, this is
the first one's
good. It's respectable. Good, right? And then they get fucking weird. Dream Warriors is awesome.
Yeah. No, I read it.
Revenge is kind
of
terrible.
I read this great deconstruction of Freddy 2, mm-hmm. which is the weirdest Freddy because it doesn't really connect. Freddy doesn't act like himself, and it does not connect to the other ones of the, like, basically one bridges into three, but two doesn't follow with one.
Which is the one with Johnny Depp, the first one?
That's
the
one.
The first one, and he reappears in six, I believe, for a cameo.
Yeah, it's
along
pretty
with
funny
Tom
cameo.
And Roseanne Arnold. Yeah. They're in there too.
But anyway, it was just about how two was like a weird allegory for being gay, and it was just
the
really
sixth
funny.
One. Sixth one's Freddy's Dead, right?
Yeah, yeah. Freddy's 3D. Dead.
And there were
Freddy's
a couple more dead. Movies. Remember that song? After
well, there was
one. There was New Nightmare.
Are you talking
Freddy
about
versus Jason?
Curtis Mayfield.
What?
That's a good closer.
Yeah.
Anyway,
but that'll be especially with the news we've got coming. Be good. Freddy's Dead.
I mentioned this in an anecdote, and since I don't give a fuck anymore. I got the entire hour-long Nightmare on Elm Street Part 5
you don't want to burn all these bridges,
novelization Chris. Audiobook. And
nice.
I think this happens at the very beginning, but it was that one thing, like, my parents didn't...
Oh, this was the story.
Nightmare on Elm Street 5 was the first rated R VHS I'd ever seen. And I love that movie. The Dream Child is the Babality in Mortal Kombat.
Is that the one with the comic book death and the motorcycle death, or is that
no.
4?
Yeah, no, it is 5.
Okay.
It is 5. The Roach Motel...
I remember the motorcycle when the motorcycle takes over the guy's body and like
creepy.
The wires
goes
into
his
finger. Yeah,
but
in a weird way, like Final Destination became is what
kind of
yeah. It's like they think of a premise and like, well, what's something we can just redo every time? Yeah. Like what?
Let's just think of a new dream.
But
kill.
Now, like an unseen death is Freddy in Final Destination. Give me because
they all die in comical ways.
So my parents, I told this before, but my parents hated Nightmare on Elm Street. Wouldn't let me dress up like Freddy for Halloween after I went and bought the glove and the mask.
Uh-huh.
But my parents were so fucking idiotically NPR liberally minded.
They were making love in Dan's bedroom.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
They let me get the audiobook and we listened to it on a road trip with my young sister and I.
He cried out.
I keep forgetting you have a sibling.
As Dan's movements became more intense.
Oh my God!
His name into her ear before he too.
This is how it started off. It was great.
They clutched one another desperately, kissing as if it were their last moment together.
Oh, Dan, that was fantastic.
Don't come.
I'm gonna take a shower.
At first, when she and Dan started dating last year, Allison thought with resignation that it would only be temporary until someone prettier and more interesting came along and captured Dan's attention.
Take a breath.
But as their relationship went on, Alice found that she was becoming prettier and more interesting.
Really?
I don't remember the movie.
Wait, can that happen?
Friends,
Alice
thought that nothing good would ever happen to her again. But that had changed. Not only was she ecstatically happy with Dan,
I can hear him
her
masticating.
Father had stopped drinking and started going to Alcoholics Anonymous. With graduation less than 12 hours away, Alice was happy. She turned on the shower, waited for the water to get hot, then stepped into the billowing steam and began to soak
you
up.
Are so lucky.
Lifting
ooh,
her
whoa,
face
whoa,
to
whoa.
The jets of hot water.
Wait, now I'm interested.
She scrubbed
so
her hair.
So this is me as like 9 years old with my family on this road trip.
The hiss of the shower. Alice stopped, frowned, and listened. The sound was coming from below.
Frowned
she looked
and
down
listened?
To see the water in the tub swirling frantically over the drain, being sucked loudly through the tiny round holes. She stepped back from the drain, frowning. The drain was sucking the water into an unnaturally violent whirlpool. The pull was so
exists.
Strong that Alice could feel her feet slipping over the bottom of the tub toward the drain.
The tub?
Slipping, until her legs flew out from under her and she landed on her ass, sliding down the tub toward the drain, fighting the tremendous pull, her arms flailing as she was sucked down into an oppressive blackness.
There's only 55 minutes
left. She plummeted helplessly until she landed in a naked heap on a cold floor.
A naked heap.
She huddled into a crouched position, hugging herself to hide her nakedness in the dim light. As she listened to the
can
sound
this just
of
be the rest of the podcast, then?
Voices, she turned slowly,
God, I heard
fearfully, and looked down a long, narrow room with plain metal-framed beds lined against the walls on either side. There were mattresses on the floor, some of them ripped to shreds. There were men moving in the shadows. Some on the beds.
Top
others
men?
Walked or crawling on the cold, dirty floor. They wore what appeared to be pajamas that had once been white. Now they were darkened by brown and yellow stains. Grimy lumps clung to the material. The men looked filthy. Their hair scraggly and shiny with
again,
grease.
Again, think me and my 6-year-old sister.
Masturbated in dark corners, grunting wetly
and
as
then my dad's like, okay, that's enough of that. Masturbating in dark corners.
Grunting,
we don't
grunting
do that.
Wetly. Grunting wetly.
Yeah.
Wetly.
That was awesome. We went to a Liquidator bookstore and like, well, if it's a book, like it must be healthy for you. And
right.
And naturally. They bought that.
No, my parents
told me. We'll be right back with a terrible dose.
We need to go grunt wetly or something.
This is Us to Spray, a.k.a. the Coltrane, and you're listening to Talk Radar. So you keep it locked, in tune, else you're going to be getting some juice, baby.
Foolish friends, Freddy Krueger is on your phone. Dial this number now. I've got some tales to tell. Freddy's favorite bedtime stories. Deadtime stories. All brand new, straight from my boiler room to your home. It's Freddy Krueger on your phone. So dial this number now, if you dare. Tell him Freddy sent you.
$2 the first minute, 45 cents each additional minute. Children, get your parents' permission before you dial.
Talk Radar, available in the iPhone App Store. Never.
So you gonna show us some of your improv skills?
Yeah, I've been doing improv today, getting my skills up, with Veronica even. Let's do a scene, Henry.
Wait, okay, we have to specify. Oh wait, no, Victoria was the cat, never mind.
Yeah. No, Brett, set us up. Give us a scene. Like, what are we doing?
What a situation.
Well, I figure, Tyler, you walk in.
Ooh,
to
a Holocaust abortion.
No.
Tyler, you walk into a very...
The vacuum cleaner was right in front of you.
You walk into an office, and a vacuum cleaner just started going off. Like, it's too loud to even talk.
Can I suggest something? What about, I want to see...
Wait, before Chris, I want to interrupt him, too.
A young black man being treated unjustly on the bottom floor of the World Trade Center on 9/11.
Okay.
Can I get...
Meanwhile, I've just walked in.
So I'm the black man.
Yes.
I've changed the scene. You're at a train station.
I'm at a train station.
I'm trying to do this, too.
You're about to board a train with Henry, but he's late. And you're wondering, you're really frustrated. Where is Henry with
The hell is this guy? We got to get on this train. How are we going to get there?
And in comes Henry.
Oh my God.
Really disheveled, out of breath.
I didn't have the right change for the machine. I'm sorry. I'm here.
Come on, man. You know this is important. We're trying to get to the big show.
That show's not so big. I've seen bigger shows.
Henry, you always say yes in improv. You always say yes.
Oh, sorry. Okay, let's go back.
Yeah, all right. Big show.
Yeah.
Henry backpedals and ruins the scene.
Okay, wait.
Meanwhile.
Wait. Yeah, I know the show's big, but, I mean, what about me?
What?
I like that neither of them can have the balls to name the show, ever. Ever.
None the of show is Chris Antista's burlesque sensation.
Testicular burlesque hour.
Yes, you have tassels on your... testicles.
All right, come on,
you're just spinning them around.
Let's get back into the scene. I want to keep.
No, you know what? No.
No.
Right,
no
Henry, more. You ruined this. New scene.
Okay.
New scene.
Okay.
New scene. I won't talk.
Woo. All right.
So the new scene.
Henry, you are standing at the top of a high dive at a public pool, and you're too scared to jump.
Oh.
Tyler.
Uh-oh.
Is the next in line and really, really wants to get on that diving pool.
Come on, man.
All right.
Are you gonna jump or what?
Oh boy, this looked a lot lower to the ground. from the ground. Oh boy!
Henry come on, is man. Playing himself.
Give me, give me some room.
All right. I'll back up, but you got to jump because I want to go. I'm practicing my Olympic dives. I'm in the Olympics.
Really? You look pretty young to be in the Olympics.
I'm 26 years old, Henry.
Really?
26 years old.
Well, so when were you born?
I'm old to be in the Olympics.
Hey, you two, quit talking and jump.
I just can't take all this pressure. Can you soothe me? Maybe if we sing together.
Maybe if we sing. What would you like to sing, Henry? What will make you jump?
Let's sing.
Think of something depressing.
Sing Van Halen's jump.
Let's sing, yeah.
No. Sorry, I know the lyrics, too.
Jump. Go ahead and jump.
All right.
Ah, Henry, let's sing Fly Me to the Moon. I know that one.
I know for a fact you don't know the word jump at all.
No.
No.
I know Fly Me to the Moon. Uh-huh.
Fry Me to the Moon?
Fry me to the moon.
Guys.
That was fun.
That was amazing.
I would like some credit for
amazing.
Thinking of this fucking high
fantastic, bro. Fantastic.
We should have 1 minute improvs every episode.
Oh, yeah, no. We're going to have a little improv theater.
Well, we would if one of us weren't leaving.
If only this podcast was still going to be happening.
Come on. Don't tease it too much, buddy.
I'm just saying, we're not going to make it to 200.
No.
If only we weren't all killing ourselves at the end of that episode.
Not now. Oh, I will be. I actually brought cyanide.
Cyanide, huh? You know, I was thinking about it. You know, a lot of people, you know, when they think about where they put the gun to their head when they do
right.
it. Like,
we were talking about this at PC.
But, Gamer. Like, look, man, it'd be hard to, but I'd want to shoot through the back of my head out
way.
The front.
No way. Why, then the exit wound will just fuck up your
face.
Yeah.
But you can never have an open casket fuel.
I want to do the in the mouth thing. That's what I would do.
What would Francine say?
Speaking of killing yourself, in my meeting today, here's another Logan Decker story. I said, like, Logan, what are you doing? Because he had his head on the table and was telling me he had mono. And he was making that up. But and then he said, you know what? I hope I die so you're sad. And then the meeting
like
was over.
14-year-old would say.
Then you'll be sad for like a day.
Yeah.
The whole day you'll be sad.
You'd all go to my funeral and you'd remember how you wish you'd treat me a lot better then.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, boss. You want to watch Twilight?
I know. We did, actually. We spent the day watching Twilight. That's what we do.
I didn't notice
that's
because
why I hate print.
They're repairing our parking lot in the at this building.
Yeah, they basically just made skid marks. That's all they
did
for a
donuts.
Day.
They did our donuts
did
in our own parking.
They did donuts with small forklift vehicles.
Suckers, we're going to do donuts in your park. But anyway, we had to all park on the other side.
Mm-hmm. Nuts.
So when I walk in yesterday, the second floor, which we don't live in, it's
there.
ComScore.
Yeah.
There's a giant picture of Robert Pattinson or whatever his name is.
Really?
Like Twilight vampire.
Edgar,
like
sparkly dude.
Like pointed out the window and it's huge. Nice. It fills the whole window and I'm like, what the fuck? I've never noticed this before.
Advertisers.
And what's
do
it doing?
You respect ComScore's numbers. They have a giant picture of Robert Pattinson in their office.
Who was the great Cedric Diggory.
Okay. So who do you think? Whose analytics are you going to trust?
Or wait.
Those
wait.
Guys?
Let me grab the Mad Magazine here.
Oh, please. I'm so glad it's still there.
Yeah, what was his name?
And figure out what Cedric Diggory's name
I also
was.
Love, this is a Harry Potter issue of Mad, and I love that on the cover it says, satires of all 8 movies. It's like, when did Mad start calling out that it's a satire?
They've always called them satire. I think that's part of a joke.
His name is
no.
Eccentric Buggery.
Oh,
goodness.
Gracious.
You need to put that down.
Great balls of goddamn fire.
And Che Chow is cha-ching.
I mean...
I want to say, like... For $5.99, like this has gotten a lot of use out of
$5.99 is pretty good as far as man.
Yeah, exactly. We had to, somebody had to pay for that Freddy Krueger DLC.
No, we got it for free.
Right. You didn't have to. We didn't want to do inside
I'm
baseball.
Sorry. Well, if we're going to the question of the week, I have some responses.
Do you have
to
any
last
game
week.
Deals, Chris?
Yeah, gaming deals.
The
Chris,
short answer is advice. No. No, I don't.
Oh wait, I saw one today that's probably
hold
over
on.
Today.
I need the music then. Oh my god.
Yes! Take my advice. Do as I say. Save a little money for a rainy day.
I haven't heard that in so long.
Oh, because we have deals all the time, man.
Boo. So, the one I saw was that on Amazon, four Square Enix DS games are cut down to $15. But most importantly, Chrono Trigger is $15, as is The World Ends With You.
No, it's $15.
Oh. But Chrono Trigger, like, $15, that is a steal. Like, 130% worth it. Like, if you never play Chrono Trigger, you must. Stealing? Well, no, I'm saying it is. I'm condoning something that's like a steal.
Okay.
And paying money for things that metaphor, are steal-like.
It's okay. Yes. It's okay. Well, I'm all right with analogies, similes, metaphors.
And that's it.
All right. Wait, we also have
we can't still be in game deals.
Zombrex edition of
Dead Rising.
Dead Rising 360 PS3 1999. The new egg.
Who's gonna name their company form?
And I keep you can't really beat this Amazon buy one get one half off thing that they're doing, basically only to combat Best Buy's buy one get one half off.
Wait, so that's going on this week.
Yeah, there's a new one.
What?
Like, every time Best Buy does something,
right?
Amazon does something to ruin it. Like, we already are selling all those games for $10 less.
Yeah.
So
I kind of want to get Catherine.
Catherine. Oh. I mean, the ones I see highlighted here are like Fear 3 is $56. New Vegas is $20. Portal 2 is $37. Like, pretend you didn't fucking own them. Jesus.
I can't. I can't pretend I'm not at the top of the world.
Oh, right. I know a good deal. You know, next week, El Shaddai comes out, which I've been enjoying so far.
I've heard good things.
It's a $60 deal.
If you buy it at full price at $60, you do get $10 off your next Amazon purchase.
Oh, it's one of those deals.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So you would recommend El Shaddai before the review is
I've
even
heard
out.
Really good things from P-Town.
From what I am allowed to talk about playing in a preview context, which is the first few levels, I feel very positive about it, yes.
Seems pretty cool.
It's been in Japan for a while, though, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So if you were in Japan, what would you tell me?
It's Japanese for the Shaddai.
Yeah, I would tell you that the American embargo is still Tuesday. So.
Let's pretend we're in Japan right now. Should I buy this game?
Do not understand you, Round Eye.
Jeez.
What? See, more brown, more improv.
But if for the sake of pre-ordering it to get that $10 credit, I like JRPGs of yore, but yearn for something.
No,
better.
It's not a JRPG.
Different.
If you
quite different.
If you like beautiful things that look amazing, old and you and also like
others laughed as they picked
like,
at their
and if you like, mean. Say the combat. If you like deep-ish combat, like, say, from Ninja Gaiden, but not as frustrating, but definitely a challenging game, and a very kind of postmodern game, too, and very creative, if you like that, I think you might want to pre-order.
If you like blonde dudes who you're not quite sure their gender...
You're not quite Aryan enough for me.
Well, when they created the characters of Enoch and Lucifer in the game, like it seems they seem made to have a slash fix.
Enoch was like a Japanese meme for
Enoch
quite a while. Enoch, like his face is just so perturbing.
Actually, I'm playing it in Japanese and subtitled per the suggestion
of
the guy. No, the guy
you would.
The guy, well, Shane Bettenhausen, who is a very influential person to me personally as a work as a writing man, like he was, and he was showing, like maybe it's not fair that he was like showing me El Shaddai. That I was like, yeah, you're right, El Shaddai, yeah. And then, but he said, look, we put in the subtitle thing. I think you want subtitles. I know you like Evangelion like me, and I was like. You're right, I do. Yeah, it should be subtitled.
I'm just telling you, we spent thousands of dollars recording American voice actors, but they suck.
Yeah, but it's still just going to break down to being Leonardo from
Ninja
Turtles.
It was funny hearing him say that, and then like I could almost feel like the PR person bristle at him saying, like, look, he kind of said, hey, I think the American voice actors are good, but come on, the Japanese.
Subs, not dubs.
What the biggest thing to take away from El Shaddai is that Metatron is actually biblical and not a robot.
Yeah, yeah.
Metatron was a key character.
Metatron.
In his Dark Materials.
How is that a biblical reference and not some kind of like Megatron?
Guys, I'd love 2. To have 0. You go on. Can I just close game deals for a second?
Yeah, yes. Go ahead.
Right. Take my advice. Do as I say.
Hang on.
Save a little money for a rainy day.
I don't know why that was irritating me so much.
No, you got to close it out. Because otherwise the rest of the podcast would be in game deals, and that would
really... It's like not closing in parentheses.
Yeah, it's
like
bad.
I did a little on Tuesday's episode.
How dare you.
But, I mean, let's not spoil the El Shaddai talk I'm going to have for real on the next episode.
Right.
Man, it's going to be all me next Tuesday, guys. Going to be talking about El Shaddai, and I'm going to be talking about my trip to see WWE 12.
And your last
Henry.
Show. And your last show ever.
Yeah, you're forgetting something. Come on.
I'm going out with a bang, guys.
I'm going out with a whimper and a rape. I don't have any. I'm out of funny. That's funny.
Right.
That's why I cannot
Come
wait
on.
For the news.
Chris did run out.
I'm just glad to put it all behind me.
He's even moving out of my apartment.
No.
Yeah, it's my
You need
now.
Somewhere to live.
There's something like I can't blame Tyler. Like, but
oh, this
like
is bad.
We're both
being roommates.
Terrible people.
We're horrible people.
But like, what do you want to do tonight? We'll probably just drink a bunch of whiskey and watch whatever we want. And like, just the whole apartment is terrible. Like Tyler's like, I was thinking of doing the dishes. I'm like, that's if we had dishes plural. We have one dish.
And the thing is, I couldn't even convince myself to do the dish.
Do the dish.
Like, I didn't. I was just like, oh man, I have 24 hours.
Like our living room coffee table is stacked with HD DVDs, VHSs, and Blu-rays.
Just go.
What the fuck?
The last time I visited, you were. Subsisting on Welch's
fruit snacks. Yeah. We use the same coffee mugs every time.
No,
we don't wash them.
Tyler doesn't. Also, we don't work together anymore. Like, living together with Tyler is awesome. We come home, we drink, and we play Street Fighter and watch whatever we want.
No,
it's awesome.
I liked when you said,
more parents telling us.
No, that was what Chris said. Was like, oh, this is like my childhood dream. All I needed.
Yeah,
you know what?
All kids, I needed was for that girl to move out.
It really is everything you imagine, but everything you imagine involves possibly like having fleas. I don't know. I keep finding bug bites on me. And
well, yeah. So your apartment no longer has the woman's touch.
Our apartment is
horrible.
Now I have a giant bed with one person sleeping in it. So the other side is reserved for Planet of the Apes comics, apparently. So like that's what happens.
That's also my bed.
There's no sheet on it or anything.
Carolyn's
like,
been sheet out for like the last week because she's house sitting and like. Oh my god, like yeah, the other side of the bed just becomes, oh, I'm done, it goes there. And it's like a pile of comics.
Yeah, that's my half of the bed.
It's
the laundry I did but didn't fold or put away.
Yeah.
We're having fun together. And like last weekend, like I'm not leaving or doing anything. And like I'm like, this apartment is fucking filthy. 48 hours. Could not
lift one piece of trash.
No. Like, well, I could, but 7 hours of Adult Swim are coming.
Oh my god, of course. You guys want to hear about the dream? My bed's inflatable. It's got five firmness settings.
This is me jumping in bed with Tyler.
Yep.
Yep.
And now you're ahead. Then you land in Tyler's apartment.
You crashed hard into bachelorhood, I gotta say. You really?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I did.
I'm already. I don't know. I really. My desk is a mess compared to everybody else's. I'm like,
Michael.
I can't imagine. But, like, you know, Michael's a mess. As in, there's like three PS3s, and 360. I have Chip and Dale figures and insurance booklet.
No, Michael's got like layers of hoarder style garbage on his desk. Like it's
we have former hoarders producers working here, so
we
should have them come by and do a little segment.
I'm not hoarding it, but I'm like the amount of shit I have. If I devote 1 minute to this, it's a waste of my fucking time in this office. It's like, I'm not using that section of the desk, clearly. I'm using the computer portion.
But at home, we should do...
Oh, yeah. Home.
I mean, I have, like...
Would you like me to come over? Because I love cleaning.
Oh, please do.
I love cleaning.
Like, I finally...
Really? And I will tell... And I will make you guys clean.
That sucks. Like, I like putting things in order, but I don't like cleaning.
Like, I want to... I got no problem cleaning.
There's a... girl I want to impress, but I want to maintain my apathy, and I just don't know how to do both.
You're going to have to commit to one of those feelings eventually.
I know.
It's
like I'm constantly explaining our place, like, oh, well, last night we were...
Because...
There's 20 beer bottles on the table because we had a part... No, it was actually just me. Those are all mine.
Like, feigned disinterest gets you in the door.
Right. But
it totally
only
works.
For so long.
You're in there.
But eventually you have to, like, it can commit to the interest. Or,
no, like, you have to, like, clean up eventually.
Yeah.
Because otherwise you're showing, like, you're not worth me cleaning
up. Tyler's seeing a lady, and, like, whenever she's just, like, I feel embarrassed. Like,
I'm like, embarrassed for me.
Well, what was it when there was a woman in your apartment? Didn't she say that she was the only thing keeping it clean? Like, she
it was true,
but it wasn't that like. Like I always said, if you ask me to clean something up, I'll fucking do it. Like, oh, was that dirty? I'll have no idea.
Yeah,
I'll have no idea what's
like,
dirty.
What is dirty?
I did
dirty.
Laundry 2 weeks ago, and I took my laundry out, and like, well, I got to fold it while it's still warm. And I just left it on the fucking... My whole floor is just folded laundry for 2 weeks. Like, it would never... Like, I don't walk over there. Like, I don't care.
I know.
It makes it easier for me to see. Like, it's great. This is the best shelf ever. The carpet. Like,
it's like, I'm like, oh, the kitchen floor is dirty. It's the floor. So what?
Yeah, right? It was only at a certain point where, like, man, these white sheets are really yellow. and things kind of snake in here.
Yeah, that's
like,
bad.
Something has to be done.
I have to be able to smell it.
You're listening, ladies.
Single.
Come on over.
We'll be at PAX.
But she
owned all the dishes, too.
She owned all the dishes. We have one dish.
Nothing. Dude, seriously, we just go dish. To IKEA. Come to the East Bay and we'll go to IKEA together.
Again, I'm not blaming anybody because Tyler and I, like, I can literally think of 1,000 things better to do than go to IKEA.
What could we do? What could we do? We could watch anything.
We could do anything. We could go
down to play Street Fighter.
Yeah, we can go play Street Fighter for a little bit.
IKEA can be a fun adventure.
Go have a beer.
I've been to IKEA once in my life and it was like a year ago and it was like horrible. You guys have to do this?
Awful.
Yeah. You need plates.
No, I don't like Swedes.
I don't like Swedes.
I don't because we don't have any pans, so I can't cook.
Go to Target. No, I'm saying
they're opening one up. When they open that up at the Metreon, we'll go.
We don't have glasses.
Dude,
we only have mugs.
Tan Friend. You have a car. Go to Tan Friend.
No, I do.
They want to get their nose. That Target sells booze, too, if that helps. Well, they want to get the cheap. No, they want to save money. IKEA is the cheapest. You're going to pay the Target premium. Go to IKEA, and you can just get $1 plate.
Yeah, the Target premium.
The Target premium, which is like over Walmart.
Target's priced me out of the car.
That's called sales tax.
IKEA is cheaper. It's a provable.
You're right. I agree.
And also, I want you guys to come visit me in the East Bay.
Move over here where the rest of us are.
Come on.
Yeah, why
come on.
We do
well,
that?
What does it matter anyway? I mean,
yeah.
It costs us $4 just to get there.
It costs us $4 in an hour.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, that's the same thing it is for me every
then
time.
Get over here.
Yeah. What's the one weird thing in this equation?
None of my
friends are coming to see me. I have to go see all of them. Like, what's the problem here?
What do you think?
What's the problem here?
Yeah. I need new friends.
Oh, burn.
That ain't the case.
Fine.
Tell you what.
Go hang out with your East Bay.
We're going to do a poll. If more people want me to live with you in Tyler Wilde.
Okay. Yeah.
We'll move on. I cannot say how much I'm kidding because living with Tyler and not working with him has been the most fantastic.
Oh, that's good. Happened. Yeah, I'm glad we don't work together.
We're not bitching in a loop about the same problem.
No, we're bitching about different problems.
But
it's
now,
in
like, and like, yet, like yesterday, we were just like talking about things we'd like to do and helping each other out with ideas toward things on different things. And I had optimistic work dreams.
By the way,
Veronica Belmont heading a website. Where Shane Patterson worked.
That would be good.
And he was writing an article called 188 Badass Movie Suicides. And
awesome.
Shane needed one. Like, I don't know, should we put True Romance at the top? That's kind of a suicide. I'm like, I'm jealous. I'm so happy for you. You get to do this.
I hope The Room is number 2. Because that's a
Did
great
you guys finish
suicide.
With a three-way in your dream? Or
Who? No, yeah. It wasn't anything like that. It was more
that's
of an...
That's not as exciting.
Yeah, gross, Henry.
Anywho,
those are our coworkers.
What do we do now? I don't. Fucking
Anywho, hey, can I just say something quickly because I didn't mention it regarding ideas, PC Gamer.
Mm-hmm.
I mentioned our PAX panel earlier. Mm-hmm. I mentioned that there are big announcements, but it's not just game publishers who have big announcements. PC Gamer has a big announcement, and it might be precisely what I was hired to work on. You thought I was just sitting there editing pages for a magazine. No, we got
big
shit.
I saw from a picture, an MS Paint picture, that you went to work for a dying medium.
Yeah, no. But you think that, but wait till PAX and we'll talk about it.
I hate saying that to you. That picture is so fucking funny.
No, it is awesome. And you know what? Printing stuff on paper? It's good. I like the magazine. I love the magazine. But we got new stuff brewing.
Hey, I have a Logan story I'll tell real quick.
Go ahead.
It was the day after PCGamer.com relaunched, and I was congratulating him on it at our Friday bagels.
Did he say, fuck you?
No, I said, he's like, thank you, thanks. And then I said, I heard PC Gaming is dead. Is that true? And then he said, Force lightning, and he just like pretended to
Did
be
he
zapping
force
me like
you?
Tom
he promised. He pretended to be force lightning me like Palpatine.
He actually literally tased me the other day. No, he didn't.
Damn it!
That would have been great if he did, didn't it?
What do we do now in the show?
Yeah, community question of the week.
Is this about games or some shit?
What was the question of the week?
It was a very game centric question
what?
Of the week
oh,
last
good.
Week.
Because that's what this is about.
It was about which. Game Boy Advance games, do you want to be the final downloadable
ones?
Do
you want an answer, Elson? You weren't here? I said Mario Golf.
So the ones, let me just go over the ones that have already been announced,
right.
Are Yoshi's Island, Mario 3, both of the, they're both remakes.
Turbo?
Super Mario Kart Super Circuit, Metroid Fusion, WarioWare Mega Micro Mini Games, Micro Mega, whatever.
Doesn't matter.
No, wait, I'm almost done. Kirby and the Amazing Mirror, and Mario vs. Donkey Kong. Mm. So that's what's been announced so far, all Nintendo-published games.
Well, who else are they going to get it? Yeah.
So what would you, just one off the top of your head, Brett?
Well, I mean, they already said Metroid Fusion, but I love Zero Mission so much.
Yeah, Zero Mission is great.
Zero Mission is fantastic. It completely negates the point of the original Metroid and is perfect. And I would probably also put in, just for the sake of it, Final Fantasy Tactics Advance, because it's...
That will be difficult.
Yeah, it's. So, I mean, it's Square, though. Square and Nintendo.
Square is currently selling one of their tactics games on iPhone for $15. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But fine. Oh, I don't know any of those.
Nintendo.
I was going to say Dig Dug, but.
Sure. Nintendo is very close with. Nintendo's getting very close to Square and
Dig Dug's a shit. Come on. Oh, well, I mean, any of that, like Aria of Sorrow would be great.
Yeah.
That's a fantastic GBA game.
It won't happen.
Konami's not doing anything with it.
And if you were to pick a Nintendo published game other than
Zero Mission. I mean, other than that, I don't even remember what all they put out. It was like, here's all the Mario games again.
Yeah.
Golden Sun.
Yeah.
That's why I want to see what other people say.
Let's not double up. Yeah. So there were a lot of repeats, so I'm going mostly with the people who said it first in the forum. Mm-hmm. But Dark Tone brought up WarioWare Twisted. And Advance Wars, which I wholeheartedly agree with. Advance Wars.
Yeah, where the fuck is Advance Wars?
That one's almost so like dense, like they might just want to save it to sell it, but it'd be so good.
A franchise Nintendo cares about.
Also, WarioWare Twisted, you might think like, oh, they can't emulate that because it involves there was a thing in the cart that did movement, but there's an accelerometer gyroscope in the 3DS, like it would work perfect on it. Genetically altered something or other, it cut off. He brought up Minish Cap, as did Cluster Shard.
Yes.
And also Metroid Zero Mission, Cluster Shard brought up.
Yep.
Perfect. And also the Cluster Shard also said the Link to the Past GBA game that also came with Four Swords. That's not going to happen though, because Four Swords by itself,
it will
the
be
GBA
free.
Four Swords is coming out by itself for free.
For free.
Monocled Yao Guai said one word, one number, Mother 3.
Well, yeah.
Never. Woo! Never, never, never. They're not going to translate it. They'd have to. If they did the Mother Trilogy as a 3DS game and just had all three on it, and then they could just relocalize all three at once.
I would imagine there's like 17 Beatles songs in there.
Remind me
to Lando81 sent me some game music ripoff that you can.
You are tearing me apart something.
Lisa. I guess Lisa.
Metabots AX.
Fuck that.
Fucking weird.
Metabots?
Yeah.
What's that old Battle Be Demon while we're at it?
Acer was the first to bring up Golden Sun. Acer was the first to bring up the Golden Sun games, but there were many fans of that weren't there.
Hamtaro.
SoxKnight1127 brought up Pokemon Emerald. Since Ruby and Sapphire will be remade, Emerald probably won't be directly remade. And Castlevania Circle of the Moon. And then
it'd be nice to play it on a backlit screen that's like dedicated backlit, not an afterburner GBA modifier.
JMarcella09 said, all right, because I know no one is going to say it, Hamtaro Heartbreak.
I said that as a joke because one of my friends like loved it, and I heard it was really
good. I'll ham your Taro. Yeah.
It was Nintendo's attempt Hamtaro was very popular in Japan.
Thank you.
And then they're like, oh, we could bring it to America. It'll be just like Pokemon again. And they basically gave it the exact same... They attacked it the exact same way they attacked Pokemon, which was they got the anime series all primed and ready, released the game on the same day the anime started, and then like was using the anime to teach kids about Hamtaro, but it was just about having a virtual...
Sorry.
Yep. They do love sunflower seeds.
Hamtaro was really big, like early 2000s.
But Hamtaro... The difference between Hamtaro and Pokemon is... Hamtaro is a virtual pet, and Pokemon is about getting everything, and you'll never be complete. Like, one inspires more devotion than the other.
Be complete.
Keep going.
And there was Booble Drop said Pokemon Pinball. The Japanese Rhythm Heaven that was Rhythm Tengoku that was only on the Game Boy Advance. And Wario Land 4. Which, that was nice. And then lastly, the Tingler said it could only be one man, Duke Nukem Advance.
Really?
I would add to that list Superstar Saga.
Yeah, Superstar Saga.
Mario
and
Luigi
good.
Superstar Saga is so good. And then also Mega Man and Bass.
Yeah, Mega Man Bass. That was a remake. It was a SNES remake, wasn't it?
The only time it ever came out in the U.S. Because there was Mega Man 7 in the U.S., but we didn't get Mega Man and Bass. Chris walked out of the room, but I assume he was going to lead into
Punk.
What the new question of the week was going to be.
I don't know anything about this.
Well, also...
Fire Emblem.
Fire Emblem, yeah. I love Fire Emblem.
And I'm surprised no one said Battle Network.
Did say Fire Emblem. Nobody said Battle Network, though. But... yeah, Fire Emblem's great. You know, Fire Emblem only came out because of Smash Brothers Melee. Like, everybody was so... They took a risk by putting Marth in it. And then they're like, oh, we'll put Marth in it for our Japanese fans. And America's like, who the fuck is Marth? But then Marth is so stupid overpowered, he became a favorite in the hardcore circuit.
Yeah, I didn't know anything about Fire Emblem until Roy and whatever their names. Also, I'm surprised no one said Sonic Advance, because that's totally up for grabs.
One more did say Sonic Advance.
Okay. Because, Sega will totally, put that on there.
We'll release it all the time.
Shit.
But I feel like the free games are all going to be Nintendo published.
They have been so far.
Just now I have to wear different pants. Henry, can you verify?
Did you really? You had to pee that bad?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I really
did. Why didn't you pee in the break?
That was like fucking 80 minutes ago, dude. Like, how was I supposed to know? This is terrible.
Santa Claus Saves the Earth.
Literally. What?
That's a Game Boy Advance game.
Did one of you pause the Hamtaro song?
Yes. No, it finished.
I don't believe it did. Anywho, where
so
are
that
we?
That was that question of the week.
What's this question of the week? What's your favorite Curtis Mayfield song? That's all I can remember.
Santa Claus Saves the Earth. That's all I'm saying.
Wow.
A GBA game.
It exists.
Well, the one I was going
from
to...
From Telegames.
I have that... Why don't you dab? Damn! Like, look at this shit. Like, I
tried
to
pee
super fast.
Buddy, that is a lot.
Wow.
That's a lot of pee.
Like, up the dab. And I'm going to try and wear these pants for the next 2 days.
But those are dark jeans, though.
I mean, it'll go away in a second. This happens occasionally. Do you dab?
Well, I was going to suggest what game character you would name a pet after.
Oh.
How about that?
But I don't know if Brett maybe had a good for you, Brett.
Well, I just had... that's fine. I also thought... weren't you suggesting something, Chris, about... didn't you suggest, what Warner Brothers character you'd like to show up in Mortal Kombat?
But seriously, Warner Brothers has been around since, I think literally 1900. Character... I think that... The Count of Monte Cristo, anything that happened with New Line, including the Ninja Turtles.
Well, I've got a good
fucking The Matrix.
The Matrix.
I've got a good answer for this. You want to really do it?
Sure.
Okay.
Sure. Well, Warner Brothers character that should be in Mortal Kombat. Yes.
Question 172. Mine is a bit out of left field. I think.
Can I do this super fast? I'm sorry. Honey.
All right. Yes.
I didn't. I want to get into some news. Lando says, I got two game songs that sound alike. I'm like, yeah, let me see them. I bet they're not.
Batman?
Wow.
I've already done this.
All right. Well, he's.
Yeah.
Never mind. Lando, Brett says, fuck you.
No, I just know we did this before. Sure.
All right.
But no, the Mega Man 2 character select screen is identical.
Wow.
From Batman.
It is the character select screen.
Yep. It's so strange that
I'm
happened.
I'm embarrassed now.
Well, all right. Well, why don't you go first, Chris?
Riggs.
Riggs.
I want him to be a player. I really want a mulleted Mel Gibson to be a playable
character.
So he'll
be a kung fu expert.
Eventually, his special move will be going crazy, stripping naked, and wishing death upon himself.
Will he break into acting like Curly?
Why not? I think every character should do that. I already said I want Neville Longbottom. No. I want to play
a
fighting
badass
game as the new Neville Longbottom.
Did you see that buzz on BuzzFeed?
I was brought up because I said that shit, because that dude has grown up to be a handsome motherfucker.
Dude, notice
he's
fixed
supposed to be
his
a fat,
teeth,
slubby
too,
loser.
Though.
No,
well,
he wore fake teeth.
Horrible. Okay.
He wore fake teeth.
Yeah, no, he was hired to be the loser fat kid. And then just as in the books, as Neville Longbottom matured and grew to be a badass, like, so did the actor. And now he's, like, a beautiful man.
And I have one more. Mm-hmm. And this should jog your memory. Oh, Spike from Gremlins.
Yeah.
Like, I would love to see that.
Dun, 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 dun,
Warner Brothers has so many fucking characters that it owns. Mm-hmm. Seeing Freddy Krueger released there, I wish I would have done it, like, proposed an article, like, what film characters would you like to see go into a Warner Brothers game? Because now they can do that for
Foghorn
fucking
Leghorn.
Ever. That can work!
Foghorn Leghorn is my answer.
Say a say.
Commercial. If I was to pick a Looney Tune, I'd go with like classic Daffy Duck, who's like crazy violent.
Foghorn Leghorn.
Well, that's what I was going to say before you guys get to it. I would say Judge Doom from Roger Rabbit. It's there involved. Pull some strings, man. It's a fucking fantasy.
All right. I'll allow on, it, man. But not in the question of the week threat.
Just allow it.
Like, that kind of shit I will come down on. Don't do what Brett did.
Like, you'll even look at the thread.
I might.
And then my answer is a bit out of left field, even more out of left field than the Looney Tunes. You know what Warner Brothers owns? DC.
Yes!
Now, wow. Mortal Kombat versus DC didn't work, but that's because they had the fucking Justice League in it. You pick a harder edge.
Lobo!
Like Lobo or Joker or Deathstroke.
But they don't want to see someone like Joker murdered because it's too iconic. But Lobo,
Lobo
gets killed all the time.
Such
they
inside.
Really think that matters. Like, Joker's a kid's character. I'm sorry. I thought he was he's practically a Hamlet villain.
Well, that was also what Yoshinori Ono's defense on why, he had nice things. There was an interview. He had a lot of nice things to say about Mortal Kombat, but he was like, no, you're not going to see Chun-Li with her spine ripped out or Ryu's head bouncing on the floor.
It just doesn't mix at all, which is why MK versus DC is such
Joker
a weird...
Joker being a murderer works...
Right.
Yeah.
The Joker being murdering. He shoved a pencil in a guy's face in a PG movie.
PG-13.
Shut up.
Chris, what was the first PG-13 movie?
Temple of Doom or Gremlins.
Okay.
No. Depends on what you want to say.
They got might have been re-rated, but they were both rated PG. Like, PG-13 was in response to them.
Yes, but PG-13 was in response to Gremlins, but I think Temple of Doom was the first one to get it.
I don't think so.
Yeah?
I don't think so, Tim.
Am I wrong?
I don't think so.
Hey. What a reference.
Don't take a Home Improvement reference from Tyler.
It was introduced in July of 1984. Does that help?
It is Gremlin.
You know, I think, when we saw Gremlins and at the Midnight for Maniacs, and the guy brought up...
It caused a conversation that created the PG-13 rating.
Yeah, he also... I was just saying when we were there, that guy brought up Temple of Doom and was the only person in the audience, booed Short Round. I think Short Round sucks and ruins that movie.
Yeah, you're wrong.
The first movie to be distributed was PG-13 rating in response to Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom and Gremlins.
Soldier.
So it was not them.
What is it then?
The first film, 1984.
All right, wait. Let me take a guess.
We've seen this at the Castro Theater.
Have we now?
All of us. Well, the three of us at least.
I'm going to
say... And there's a remake in the works.
Red Dawn?
Yes.
Wow, really?
Wow.
That's PG-13?
Yeah.
Like women are violently shot for no reason. Mm-hmm. In elongated sequences,
Where in real life? The world's
in Rwanda. Where looking into our analytics, we have one bright code.
The world is in PG-13, man.
Even as a kid, I didn't like Short Round. Short Round is so fucking annoying. And he's,
what about
in
Goonies?
Such a terrible,
he's the same character.
I hate him in Goonies, too.
All right.
Unlike you guys, I'm not a Goonies fanboy.
Hey, shut
You're
up.
An asshole.
I watch Goonies some. And
watch
it's
it
cute.
Again.
Nah,
it's not cute. It's horrifying.
Stand By Me is better.
I don't disagree with that at all.
More trivia. The Flamingo Kid is the first movie to receive that rating, but it wasn't released until after Red Dawn.
How about that?
Order!
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 Order me some pizza.
What Warner Brothers character? Tyler?
I already told you.
What?
Foghorn Leghorn.
You did.
Or how about Patrick Swayze from Ghost?
Oh, that'd be great.
Magical
absolutely.
Powers.
Absolutely.
That'd be so great.
Absolutely.
Oh, you know what? But here's what I'm talking about. This is why it could have been a fun article. It could have been a Tommy from Goodfellas, played by Joe Pesci.
Mm.
Like
could
he could
Neo.
He could be a fun, a character in Mortal
now,
Kombat.
Now, Neo would
Neo.
Beyond perfect.
Maybe Voldemort or a Death Eater.
Yeah, old Voldemort or Bellatrix Lestrange.
Yeah.
Oh, God, or Tonks. Oh, Tonks.
I never liked
her. I liked her in the books. In the books, I'm like, I know I'm going to be attracted to her, and this is going to be my thing.
Oh, yeah,
my Harley Quinn for a long time. And no offense to the lady who plays her, but they finally cast her.
Hey, we need more Tiny Toons games. Cause those were
that's true. I want Plucky Duck.
Yeah.
Hamilton.
Buster Bust Loose for Super Nintendo. Everybody play it.
We were talking about a week of SNES games, and we always wanted to do something like that, but it turns out the SNES was the last time licensed games mattered ever.
Yeah, we'll have a whole week of stuff about the SNES, so we'll save that discussion.
Am I too sweaty? Henry knows when I'm too sweaty.
I know, now I'm too sweaty.
Well, that's our question of the week. It might be in the forums. If it isn't, put it there.
So we're getting dangerously close to the end of the episode.
Rotten Tomatoes is owned by Warner Brothers, so what if a giant tomato?
Whoa, hey!
They're owned by Fox.
Well, no. No. Well, then that means GameSpot. Oh, the GameSpot should fight them.
Yeah. Sean McKinnis. I want to fight Sean McKinnis.
Chris Waters versus...
That's CBS in Iraq. That's CBS.
That is.
I don't care that
Isn't CBS partially rather, owned by Warner Brothers?
I would much rather...
You know what?
No,
I
not,
own
not
CBS. Who cares?
Okay.
This is the end.
The answer is Viacom. Just
my
say
only
Viacom.
Friend. The end.
The answer is Viacom.
The ultimate answer.
Do you guys have something you can talk about for like 2 minutes?
What?
I want to pull a Chris. I need to run away really quick.
You too?
Yes. Just talk about a video game you're all playing
right now.
Talk about
you too.
You guys want to talk about Limbo? You just came out on Oh, you already beat that. Done.
You don't like Limbo? Is that the case?
Whoa.
When did I ever say that? No. Whoa. Henry,
you what?
Braid?
Wrong with you. Limbo way more than Braid.
No. What? Oh, good.
I like Limbo a little better than Braid.
Limbo's great. Yeah.
But I respect Braid a little more than Limbo because Braid was trying to do a ton more and it asked more of the player.
Yeah, but Limbo just kept it simple.
Limbo does have a lot of smart devices it throws in that you don't expect.
Quite fucking clever, gotta say.
And was that spiders or silhouettes?
No, there was the
box pushing
silhouettes.
There was the shifting of gravity.
How about that? Come on,
timing of things. Like
spoilers.
Tyler, tell us about your PC gamer stuff.
You want me to
tell you writing anything this month?
About what it's like? I happen to have a copy of October issue here.
Wait, how do you say that? Arkham?
Arkham City.
Oh!
Batman Arkham City.
Wait a minute, that's a console game. I don't think you guys should have
it on
our
cover. And is on the PC. And you know what? If you physics acceleration, which means you have an NVIDIA card, and I'm sorry for you. But if you do, no, I like NVIDIA, but the only card you can get with physics acceleration, you'll get crazy shit, I'm sure, that you will not get on consoles.
I thought the most hilarious thing I heard was the DRM part of that. If you pirated the game, WBI somehow knew, and you would jump from a ledge, and your
wings
would...
In Arkham Asylum.
Well, just don't... Why not steal the greatest Batman game ever made?
Come on.
It's one of those things, I don't think twice about paying for. If you charged $120 for, Chrono Trigger and SNES prices, I wouldn't think twice. I'll have some of that Arkham.
Let me tell you about this issue. First issue with my name in the masthead. I also wrote...
This is the first issue?
The Arkham City issue. I also... I did the table of contents. Those are my words. Mm-hmm. You like those. I also did a face-off against Dan Stapleton about which is more important, the beginning or end of a game. That's important stuff.
No question, the middle.
I'm going to say the beginning.
Saying the beginning, too. I don't see the end of the game I play.
Thank you very much. I reviewed a little indie game that I didn't like a whole lot. Sorry about that. Good stuff. Buy it. Go to one of those newsstands that I've heard about.
Gonna get weird.
Go to the newsstand on this.
Where would someone find one?
Can I find
Would you go to a Borders?
Oh, no, they don't exist anymore.
Go to your local airport and
pay for a ticket.
Hey, you know what's in here? It's a preview of Hard Reset. That's a PC exclusive shooter that looks awesome.
I think that got revealed on the PC Gamer website, wasn't it?
I believe
it was in a world exclusive.
Hard Reset looks fantastic. Guys, check it out.
Now, Grim previewed it this week. Yeah, good
stuff.
So Brett's back.
I think it's time we
Warner Brothers also owns. Warner Brothers also owns Under Siege.
They own New Line Cinema. Under Siege. They own HBO.
Sesame Street.
Tony Soprano could be a fucking
Sesame
character.
Sesame Street.
They don't own Sesame Street at all.
It says that on behalf of Sesame Workshop.
No, they're publishing the Sesame game, Children's Television Workshop. Sesame Street, Blockstock,
Critters.
They published Bastion, Critters. So just imagine,
Garbage Pail Kids. It can all happen.
Oh, fantastic.
It can all happen.
And they own Austin Powers.
So we had teased.
I've got a bad feeling in my tummy.
I don't even want to say it. Unannounced. And I regret to inform you. Oh, my God. there going to have to be a special guest for this?
There's going to be a... Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Wow, this is incredible.
What are you doing? Oh. I didn't know about this.
I'm going to step away for a second.
Okay. We gotta make room. We gotta make room.
No, he's gonna someone's coming in the room right now. Oh God, look who it is.
The song of a start. It is a saxophone. This is when I'm
careful, Duke, you're not like gonna be
awesome. I'm absolutely out of control. Yes, it's me, Dr. Duke Lombardi.
Duke! Oh, we
your favorite
you.
Old reference to a show forever. I can't imagine anybody listening recently has ever heard of. I have some horribly, horribly depressing news.
Oh,
one!
No.
One! London riots. That was terrible.
That's bad.
That was terrible.
It was horrible.
I really like seeing all the Clash headlines on newspapers.
Yeah.
London's burning. White riot. I really appreciated that. Lost to the supermarket. I don't know who used that one. Anywho, I'm here with some depressing news. A stalwart of this show. It pains me to tell you that.
Oh, Duke, can I interrupt you for a second?
What?
Can I interrupt you for just a second, Duke?
Sure.
What are your pants today, actually?
Right. May I keep going with the improv or something?
What are your pants made out of today?
Well, right now, at least 10% urine.
10%. That is true.
Going back to what that gentleman said before. It doesn't matter. I didn't...
it matters anymore.
Duke, I gotta stop you there.
Well, I wanted to announce...
Wait.
I wanted to announce to the world that
Wait a sec. Look, I have something to announce.
What?
Duke, you need to stop. Everybody, I need to tell you.
God.
This has been a hard thing to...
This is really upsetting.
...to bring up, but... I've been here for so long. It's been great. You guys are all my best friends.
Henry, can I interrupt you really quick before you finish that thought?
What?
I just want to say I'm leaving Games Radar and going to Capcom before the end of the month.
Oh, my God! I thought you were going to say where you're going.
Oh, well, I might as well.
Yeah, I guess. Just so you know, that's very real.
That's true.
Yes. We love you. This is very big news, I know.
I think to some extent Talk Radar is over.
No,
it's great. I'm going to prepare it all myself and
I'll pitch in more.
No, I'm not saying there's not other options, but probably not going to do this much work for Games Radar.
Well, don't put this on me that the whole fucking thing is going to
tits up. Don't do this immediately.
I never said you wouldn't.
Look, and no matter what happens, yes, I am going to Capcom. It's really hard to even say that. I'm going to Capcom after PAX. Like, PAX, obviously, I'm still Radar. We've already committed to that.
I really appreciate... This hurts me. I really appreciate... But Brett's also staying for the 24-hour marathon.
I'll be here for the 24-hour marathon.
He'll be doing PAX with us.
Like, I could have... this could have happened a little sooner, but I wanted to purposely, like, delay it so that I could still do this marathon and I could still do PAX and meet people there. With that still, you know, a final Radar send-off kind of thing. So that's another reason I was really hoping people go to PAX, because you don't need a pass to get into the party or not. Well, not having a party.
That's why we've been telling you to go to PAX all these months.
That's not why.
For years, Brett has been leading up to this.
No, hang out with Capcom's Brett Elston.
For stuff like this.
Wow. But basically, I am going over there, which... That in it of itself shouldn't be too surprising, I wouldn't think,
because my
Twitter background for all 2 years has been Mega Man. My desktop wallpaper is Mega Man. My ringtones are Mega Man.
Twitter background is Lady Gaga and Street Fighter.
That's old.
And if Disney ever offers Chris a job,
oh, dude, I would have been, like, I would actually murder several listeners just to get that job. So go
what? No, it's it.
It's such a perfect fit.
Like, what I'm doing, I'll be going over to their Unity blog and, you know, not just posting stories. I'll be posting stories over there, but, like, the position itself is, you know, we'll figure it out as, it's got a role, but I will, you know, elaborate on that as time passes, but I'll still be posting stuff there.
You'll be on the internet.
I'll be on live streams. I'm still, obviously, going
to
be...
You're not moving away, which
no,
is
no, no,
nice.
Not at all. Much like when Dan left to go to Activision, that's kind of very similar to what I'll be doing.
Well, but he moved to L.A.
He moved to LA. I will not be moving away. And in fact, Capcom is on the same highway as Future. Like, I have to drive past Future to get to and from Capcom.
Maybe he'll stop.
Parts of Mexico.
I know.
It doesn't give anybody time.
But within 30 minutes of each other is the point. Yeah. Like, I can still very easily be on the show. Like, not every week, because that's ridiculous, but...
But every other week, you're saying that right now.
No, I'm not even saying that. But like
Elton promises.
I promise. But like, I can still be on the show more. Like, right now, Seth Killian, like, who I will be working directly with, and that's fucking awesome.
Yeah. Frequent guest on our show.
Frequent guest on our show. And
super awesome guy.
Beloved, no longer.
Beloved by all.
He is not invited to the show anymore. Yes.
I'll be working with him directly, and Snow over at Capcom, Sean Baxter, like a lot of these people that I've met and like I've worked with for the last several years, and I'll be passing by every day, so
hear my tears? Can you?
Ugh, it's so loud. It's like honey,
you're so loud and filled with print money.
But like,
it feels so good.
I mean, I don't. Yeah, this has been very difficult for me to even discuss, because I had to... It's been in the talks for a while, like, maybe I would, maybe I wouldn't, and I love Radar, and this is something I put my life into, but I've also done this for 6 years, and I like the idea of doing something new, and being at Capcom is a company that I really enjoy. I legitimately love all, like, not all their games, but I mean... Breath of Fire?
Yeah.
That's good stuff.
Dark Void.
Let's not talk about Dark Void. Let's move on.
I've heard Capcom people on other podcasts that just say, like, Dark Void was a game.
No, and that's part of the reason. Capcom, for all the shit they got in the last week where everyone decided to jump on a bandwagon and bitch about Mega Man Legends 3, even though those games were never financially successful or popular, like, just because you liked it doesn't mean it was a hit for the company. I'm sorry, that's how it works. Like, Nintendo has franchises I love that will never come back. You've had to argue for almost 10 years to get another Pikmin game. It's a great game, but Nintendo, like...
I will say Advance Wars.
Advance Wars is fantastic, but like...
They just kind of dropped it.
They can do it when they can do it, and Mega Man's in the same boat right now.
I definitely don't think Mega Man... Even that we did a news story on it today, but like, I never thought Mega Man was dead.
Of course it's not dead.
Especially after 9 and 10 together, like, he could use this hiatus.
It just needs a break. Like, they don't have an idea for him right now, so they gotta wait and do something that's worth bringing that character back. Because doing Mega Man 11, would anybody care?
No. I would be absolutely.
So you want to think of some a great way to bring that character back, and I'm fully behind that. But
you might get to be a part of that.
I would love to. Who knows? I actually don't know what their plans are at all.
I mean, Seth's name has a creative credit in Marvel. Oh,
For 3 and Super Street Fighter 4 and all this stuff.
You never know.
But like, I'm a huge Mega Man fan, so if I go over there and rattle some cages, the new hire can rattle some cages in a Japanese company.
He's got a lot of ideas, guys.
This guy you can't understand. Like something your old boss.
So basically, Brett will be crawling back in a month.
Yeah, but I'll be doing that after PAX.
But this isn't your last show.
This is not my last show, because I'll be on like next week's show, and then my last show will be sometime. You know, the first one we do after PAX, but
we have to roast you.
I guess. I guess.
I mean, nobody else does.
I don't even want to do it. I just want you to do your old.
But I mean, this isn't even the first. Like, this itself is not. Like, Andy Salisbury just recently left at Gamer to go be at Warner Brothers. Shane Bettenhausen left 1UP to go to Ignition.
I should have said Dan left Salisbury all of
this
is
my Warner Brothers. The natural character. Progression of this industry.
Dan left for Activision. Jeff Green went to EA
and Bungie. Who was
That was Luke Smith.
I want to
Bungie. David Ellis that went the UFL. He left for it. Yeah. It's not an unnatural thing.
Yeah. So this, but
and it really shows respect for our jobs that they.
No,
like,
that I was you know approached and I you know discussion and
was a long.
I would
courting.
Say it's a disrespect for our
jobs. Well, no, it's a respect as in like they want us to do our jobs for them. Like they know it's important. Like,
but I mean,
like,
they don't. But the thing I love about
we can't
Capcom,
pay you enough to continue doing
the thing
your
I like
own
about Capcom
job.
Is like they got someone like Seth who is legit 100%.
He's respected. He's a cool guy.
And,
like,
and I give a shit thoroughly. about their stuff. So,
and he's way more interesting than like Major Nelson. Like Major Nelson's like a nice guy, but I don't really.
We don't need to go there.
I prefer like Dan. Like Dan is I would not want to have Dan's job. Well, just from the heart.
But even Gabe Graziani, who used to work for us, and then GameSpy, he's at Ubisoft now. So it's like this happens a lot. But like I'll still be at all the same.
I never knew.
Pick an ending.
I'll still be at all the same shows. So like when we go to Comic-Con, when we go to PAX, even South by Southwest, Capcom, and Future, we're at. Like E3, like I'll be at all those shows. Yeah. I'll be driving by
movies together.
We'll still like we're all still hanging out, and maybe there's stuff we can do outside of Radar that we just do.
Oh,
and
really?
It's us talking. Who knows?
What?
Only with
could that?
Who knows? There's plenty. Yeah. Who would rise to such an occasion?
Ooh.
But no, this is not a decision I came to lightly, and the effect of that it has on a lot of the listeners is not lost on me at all. Like I spent months.
You're not anywhere near as angry as I am.
Right, but I spent, like, I wouldn't say months, because it's not been that long, but weeks, like, agonizing over do I, don't I, but I'm really excited about this. I love that that company means a lot to me, the legacy of the company means a lot to me, the future of the company means a lot to me, and, like...
Can somebody hand me another, Brett go bye-bye doesn't hurt...
It's empty!
And see, 12 beers is not enough for a podcast. No, 12 beers is not enough for a podcast.
I am incredibly depressed about this.
But... I'm sad too. I'll be happy for Brett. So, yeah, PAX is kind of that Saturday night takes on a whole different meaning. Because
I'm in a different situation. I am not happy for you at all. Like, I'm like, how the fuck?
How dare you get to leave us?
I wanted, I would do a Mariah Carey song, like, How Do I Live?
Isn't that Leon Ram? Leon Ram.
You personally and professionally have been like
that. This is roast sounding stuff.
No, it's not. It's just like it has been incredibly important to me, and like it puts my head in the tails. Have you?
And
it's very real. Nobody's joking.
No, this is not a joke at all.
Re-emphasizing that.
Like when this whole thing when it happens was very shocking even
to
me.
I'm sitting here hitting myself in the legs, hoping it'll end.
When you first told me about it, I was just like, wow, just what does this mean for everything? Like, well, but I think Games Radar is not ending when you.
No, leave. I mean, like, you think about who's still here. It's like Chris, Michael, Charlie, Grimm, Keith, Nagata, like me, Henry.
Yeah,
Tyler, Wild. Oh.
And Liz, Lizzie's gone too.
Yeah, you were the first domino, Tyler.
I'm sorry, guys. I was the.
You were the domino that set off the snowball.
That's right.
But I mean, I still plan on like Seth is only on the show like twice a year or something. Mm-hmm. Like I
would say too much.
He talks a lot. I wouldn't want to wait until just Let's wait till a Capcom game comes out, and then I'll come over here and be like, have you guys heard about the new Capcom game? It's out this week.
I'm pretty excited for Dead Rising Off the Record.
Off the Record, Henry. I will personally come back and tell
you. Elson can only come over here to talk about Street Fighter 3 Dual Strike.
We should dig up stuff of you talking about how much you hate Dead Rising.
I do not bring up Dead Rising around me. I will... let's not.
Another person can write that blog.
All I've heard is that Brett loves Dead Rising.
I'm just saying maybe Seth will come on that podcast.
But yeah, come on. Come on more often than I do.
Sorry. Anybody want to pick an ending song?
I still want to... I was going to say a fitting ending song, a song I love, and a song that...
just send it to me. That's all that's wrong.
The Mega Man 2 ending song.
I'm not going to cry.
Well, but
I don't think we've ever done that before.
If this was going to be your true... Yeah, but you save a...
I've got a better one.
Exit song.
I've got a better one for my true exit.
Okay. I've got my true exit song.
But we did the mini bosses one, I believe, like a long time ago.
I want to do the 8-bit NES, which I cried as a child because I thought Mega Man died.
It's the end of Mega Man.
But I'd reiterate, like, I'm still here for the 24-hour marathon. I'm still going to PAX. Like, all that shit's still happening.
I'm getting upset. Is that not matter?
I'm pouring out a 40.
The impact of this is not lost on me, but, like, it's a really cool opportunity. Like, I'll still be on the show as often as I can. We're still going to be meeting up at all the same shows. I'll still be on Twitter. I'll be on Unity's blog. And it also just, like, I don't know, getting to work for a company that's that cool. Like, I know they had some rough stuff this year, like, some unpopular decisions, some news that blew up in their face, but, like... Yeah. Is that not one of the coolest companies ever? Yeah. Like, in the history of games? No. Like, just think about the legacy. How badass is that? And I'm very excited.
They kicked a Tron Bond player out of
Comic-Con. That did not happen.
That's what I heard.
And then Seth got punched in the face.
I heard that too. Seth got punched in the face. Yeah, he did.
But I think the important thing our listeners need to know is that we still get to hang out with you. Listeners.
Yes.
Yeah. We'll hang out with Brett all
the
time.
No, that's the only thing that sucks is because, like, I don't want to say this for, like, whatever my last podcast is, but, like, the best part about working here has always been you guys, and, like, leaving that is, like, that's been one of the biggest things about me deciding that is, I got a new job and meet different people. Like, we all hang out outside of work. We're going to go eat pizza, and we're going to talk, and I like going, like, we go out and drink, and we go see movies, and we talk, like it's
they
become
better
my,
not be better friends than us.
It's become my life, and to leave that is not just professionally scary, but it's, like, personally scary.
Yeah.
So I do not, like, I don't let ties go easily, so I plan on staying in touch with everyone and being in all your faces. And
we should stop before we get too modern.
I know.
Yes.
I know.
All right, there's PC Gamer panel I want to see everybody at. There's a meetup at PAX.
Two meetups at PAX.
There's a meetup at PAX. Henry Gilbert has a Twitter.
Henry, even though he's not quitting, has an ending song picked out already.
No, I thought. Well, I thought of that when Shane left. Well, mine was going to be Yub Nub. That's
going to be. I'm re-quitting just because of this.
The Mega Man 2 ending song. Because it's sad, but I will pick it up. I will pick it up.
All right. Take us out or something.
It only
onward and upward.
It gets better.